You got the shit song.
You said oh, yeah. What?
He got the shit song. He got the shit song.
That nigga.
He got the shit song, bro. We look clean as fuck.
I mean, it's just to impress.
Heck yeah, I had to.
That nigga done threw on the cloak, bro. He took me back a couple of days.
Yeah, I had one time, man.
We got to put on some music.
I'm finna go beat a nigga ass with this shit on.
Hold on, Tom. We about to go run down on a nigga. Am I too loud?
I'll run down on the mother granny and that shit. Nigga,
nigga, am I too loud, bro?
I'm about to
get
my light, bro, so that way, you know what I'm saying? A little professional.
Hey, yo, Bryce, you put that bitch on your story?
I forgot. Let me just try it.
I'm about to do that bitch right now. I'm trying to find some. What playlist am I going to pick on? I don't know what playlist to go to for. Why the fuck are we doing this? Actually, no, go back. You bitch. I knew it was going to do that. Man, fuck, I didn't want to do that. Excuse my French. I had to edit a lot of this out. I ain't gonna lie. It's gonna be hell editing this. Hey, man. Oh, my goodness. Bro, it's gonna be hell editing this. All right. We in here. Crazy No Sleep Podcast. No Sleep Podcast. One bit. With the game. Christian said he coming back too, bro. Y'all the only one in this bit? Oh. Bro, this man. Could do the focus reel so whenever somebody start talking.
Yeah, hold on. Let me get my stuff set up. I'm trying to set up my tripod and stuff.
Word.
Tripod set up, bitch. I'm using cologne to set my shit up right now. I'm gonna lie.
Hey, so yes, sir. I got it full screened up, bro, so they couldn't see Bree Candace in the back.
Hold on. Oh, damn. I gotta tell you. Yeah, they're gonna hang a beautiful name up.
Whole time, baby. This lit as a bitch. We've been waiting
to the dawn.
Yes, sir.
To the motherfucking dawn.
To the motherfucking dawn. Come here.
There you fucking go.
Yeah. To the motherfucking dawn.
There you fucking.
Yeah. Well, let me see. Hey, bro, speak. Nah, can't hear you, big dog. Turn that music down a little bit more. Where my headphones?
Why y'all hear me now?
Oh,
y'all hear me now, all right?
You said what,
hear me now? Okay, hear me now? Hear me now? Yeah, hear me now?
Yeah, bro, we can hear you, bro. Put your rotate on. Okay, there we go. Yes, sir. Hey, that's a cool setup. That's a cool setup. We can't hear you no more. What happened? Niggas just can't hear you no more, cuz. I don't know what happened, cuz. Bruh, nobody can hear you, bruh. It's not fixing. It's not fixing the situation, bro. This man,
Yo. I don't know why that bitch start tweaking when I turn my lock on.
I don't know neither. What were your? Oh, you mean your lock off?
Yeah. When I let that motherfucker turn, he just stop. You feel what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Turn it on my time. So you can hear me, right?
Yeah.
Now let's see this. Hold on. Can you hear me?
Yeah, well, I can't hear you now.
You can?
Yeah.
Oh, shit, hold on, one more time. You can hear me?
Yeah. We in here.
I'm fucking in.
We in here. We just waiting on Hazeem, bitch ass, and Chris to finish washing his ass.
Chris to finish washing his ass?
Yeah.
Okay, do your thing. I would have Jaren in the corner, but I ain't gonna do Jaren now. I'm gonna let Jaren rest.
I was about to say, where Jaren at, bro?
Jaren fell off my shit and lost his arm. So Jaren got to go.
You stay breaking some shit. You know that?
Jaren going in the trash.
It's stupid. You can fuck Jaren up. Let me see. Who else? Oh, yeah, Christian.
So 17 going in the trash.
Let me see. Wait, what you do to Android 17, bro? You don't lost that man bandana, bro.
Yeah, yeah. That motherfucker's on the wall cold chilling, too.
Yeah, you Jaren. Broke the motherfucker.
I had Jaren fighting Frieza, even though full power Jaren would smack that nigga.
You was bodying.
Yeah. It's not even a fair fight, but I had them motherfuckers set up. Then I had switched it off one time. I had Android. Are you listening to me?
Whole time. Oh, yeah. I was reading the story. My fault. All right.
But I was like, can't get someone on. Then I had Android 17 posted fighting that nigga. I lost that man bandana in his hand, so that shit dead.
Bro, how? It's not like these niggas was really fighting, though. You know what I'm saying? I'm saying, like, just can't keep shit.
No, I'm saying, look, bro, I have him high up on the wall. Like, I have him, like, to the tip top, and I be buying these shits off, like, eBay. They be cheaper. Cause eBay go for, like, $50 on Amazon. So I seen them for, like, $20 on eBay. I'm saying, like, fuck it. So the slightest bit of movement, and they life support, got him.
So, whole time, bruh, feel. And that shit was just a wrap for bruh. He fell one time.
When Jaren fell, that nigga arm was fucked up. they used some kind of PVC. So instead of having that nigga arm just looking lanky as it was, just took them bitches off. At 17, that motherfucker fell, and his leg got fucked up. I put it back on, loose as hell. And yeah. I think I couldn't find his hand. Then I fucking vacuumed. Now I really can't find his hand.
Bruh, said, damn. It's been like that for years, though, bro. Niggas is playing with toys, bro. It's some fuck-ass shit would always happen, bro. I know that's not what we doing, bro. You don't want that.
I got to see these whole cool glasses, bro. So cool. So cool.
Man, I can't put these bitches on my shades. I'm at what?
And this shit hella dead, my boy. What? It was a good try, though.
What you talking about?
I'm saying that shit not going to work,
man. What you talking about? You're talking about your glitter ass, dog. I put it on like this, though. This shit's fucking break. Man, bruh. I just need to come on, bruh. Nigga talking about getting a tripod and shit. I did kind of put him on the spot. Nah, that shit dope. That's a dub. Bruh. I don't want to get into no subjects without nobody here. You know what I'm saying, bruh? I already got my first subject.
Yeah, see?
I got plenty to talk about. It's always something to talk about, bro.
Is you at least gonna let me know what the first subject is, though? Shit.
Bro, shoot,
bro. I don't know a damn thing.
Bro, we just gonna be talking, bro. Ain't nothing to it, bro. I understand. You know what I'm saying? Like how we always do. You know, you get on the phone, you just start talking your shit. So that's what we gonna do. I'm trying to
Most work
on same bitch ass. We can just go ahead. Bring it.
Bro, who's freaky ass? throwing freak ass. I can't even speak. What the fuck is that?
Let me see.
Who is that nigga with them freaky ass glasses, bruh?
What you talking about, bro? I don't even want to check. I can't check it because we already live, bro. I'm not gonna do that shit.
I'm talking about you. See that you can see yourself on a Discord, right?
I can go to Discord on my phone. I forgot.
I'm talking about like what's up with Hazen profile picture type shit. Like who the fuck is that?
Oh, I don't know, bro. It look like some anime bitch.
I thought it was Kabuto, but
it low key do look like Kabuto, but bro, suspect for real. So.
That nigga gay as shit.
That nigga's gay.
It's the bitch from Tokyo Ghoul.
Oh, like, now you wanna talk whore?
I'm trying to set my stuff up. Hold on.
And you taking forever, you crippled bitch.
That hey, shit foul.
Y'all so delayed in my shit. I gotta leave the Discord and join back.
But.
Well, Quez is delayed, not
no,
you.
We not delayed for each other.
Yeah, no.
That's your shit,
know,
my
on
boy.
My screen, no. You delay Quez for me, but he's not, cause he left and came back. I gotta leave and come back.
Yeah. Gang shit.
Gang shit.
Hey,
whole bunch of HSB shit, bro.
Yeah. Wait, what am I gonna say?
That schedule ass, didn't it? He's also.
Yeah. Hey, I need to cut his camera on. Cut him over right back.
For a fucking second, bro.
Nah, I was gonna say, that's the bitch that got Kaneki to where he is now.
The first bitch that had put my boy through everything, bro.
Nigga thought he was finna get some ass.
He was like, he thought he was about to slide up on some quick cheeks. He was like,
nigga,
oh, man,
nigga
I struck gold.
His life was trying to take a turn.
Yeah, it took a turn, all right. Motherfucking end up.
Dude, I got his ass flying around like a motherfucking rag dog.
And then she just started devouring his ass. Imagine you getting fucking ate alive from the bottom up. Like, nigga, you just fucking
I'm
sick. That's fucking sick. She was plotting on that nigga.
I ain't gonna lie, though. No. I'm gonna keep it hot, though. She was bad as hell. She can be from bottom up, too. Okay.
No cut.
I couldn't even put my arm right.
He said, no cap. Got to see it through.
I couldn't do that shit.
No cap.
You got to see it through, my boy.
Got to see it through.
Yeah. Seemed the same shit to me. I'm
bro,
not
what
mad
would,
at
what
all.
Would you do, bro? Nah, real life, bro. You would a bitch just like 10. She a 10, bro. A smooth 10, bro. Like, she popular, right. Noticed by everybody. And then that bitch start doing that shit for that she was doing to Kaneki, bro. Like, she tried to eat your ass.
But she bad. She bad like that.
Bruh, oh, no, bro. I'm sorry. I can't go out like that. You know the motto, bro. We don't take ills for no more. Bro, but that nigga could have died.
He did he though?
Bro, but you not Kaneki though. But you not
a cold ass nigga.
But you not Kaneki though, bro. Don't we talking about like real life?
Only thing is, I probably wouldn't have thought it out like he did. He played his cards right.
Kaneki was worthless, like, though.
Alright.
That nigga Kaneki was damn worthless.
Hold on.
This nigga, oh my god.
I can hear you still.
Of course.
I'm just trying to
untangle
my
shits. Yeah.
Look stupid.
Man, bro.
All right, go ahead. What were you saying?
I'm saying, like, bro, but like, we talking about like real life, not that. Oh, you gonna turn into a ghoul type? Like, if when she eat your ass, you dead. Like, you feel me? What would you have done, okay, bro? Who would you have called on, bro? Would you have made peace with your God?
No, I feel like.
He's talking about no.
Hey, look, I feel like a nigga like me, bro. I honestly, I live every day feeling like the main character. So I gotta be like tasting duff. Like I gotta be like chewing on that shit to be like, all right.
Yeah, this
yeah,
is it.
This is the end of my chapter. Like yeah. I'm gonna have to, bitch. I'm gonna put up a hell of a fight. Ain't gonna lie. Like, you may think she a ghoul, but
I'm gonna reverse that bitch.
The way I'm feeling, like I would have tore her ass up, nigga.
Hold on, I turned to that bitch.
Matter of fact, nigga, I would have made peace with my lord. But I sure as hell would have called on his ass.
You know I would have did,
that's
bro.
That's a fact.
I would have hit that bitch with that damn how Jiren was hitting fucking Frieza. That's what I would have held with. She would have been through. It would have been no games, bro.
You would have gut punched her ass?
Bro, I would have stepped on her foot and just started going to town. I know you. How you seen how niggas are doing in Baki.
I would have told her ass respectfully. Like, If you start from the meat, you got it. You feel what I'm saying? If you just caress the meat, see, you bro, caress the meat a little bit, you can do what you feel like doing.
That goes to show, bro. All niggas think the same, man. You making us
bro, look can't bad. You get... Bro, if I call you the V-word, can't that shit get banned?
Like, bro, what the fuck is way? The V-word, bro?
I'll be like...
Hey, like, don't say that.
Like, I'll be like... No, like, I'm not gonna say it to you. I'm gonna say, like, how about this? I'm a virgin and I'm proud. If I was like, yo, you fucking, your shit would get deleted.
Maybe so. I don't know. I don't know.
I don't even know why. But bro, I heard that you, if I,
it's
if
a lot I of stuff. You,
if I insulted you by using that word, your shit would have got deleted.
Bro, it's a lot of stuff that you can say, bro. Cause I know you can't see to say the C word, bro.
What, cunt?
A nigga.
I thought it was possibly another one.
No, bro. What other word, bro? Start with a Z that you know. That's nigga.
You cockhead.
You fucking. Like that,
you some shit. I don't know.
When have you ever heard us say that bullshit?
I've been told that actually, so that's where it came.
So it probably was some old white dude that you done pissed off somewhere, bro. You know how you do it.
Nah, let me tell you. Walking home from the bus on Friday, I got a black hoodie on. I got on some bright color. I got on some blue Under Armour joggers. I think I got crack on. They all chilling.
About to Trayvon somewhere Martin your she, ass.
Chill out. Some Jamaican.
That shit ain't funny.
So, that shit not right. So...
Oh, shit.
Some Jamaican lady out the window. Get out of here. You are up to no good. What the fuck? I'm like, this is you my own people. You know what I'm saying? I'm like, yeah, you get out of here. You know up to no good. I'm like, I'm not doing that. She's like, you suspicious. Get out if I call the cops.
Bro, so she was like, just shook, bro. You shook up that lady, so, man.
So she's like, get out of here. I'll call the cops. So you know what I said? I'm like, you get out of here.
You told that lady that bullshit.
I was like, how about you get out of here, bitch? I was like, how about you go?
You ain't shit. You ain't shit.
So you know she,
what?
She took her phone and she showed me. And she just flashed that motherfucker. She was like, final warning. I was like,
well, she was about to call the police on you, bro.
I'm like, you call him, I call her. You go. It was like, oh my god, she is lamenting. I'm like, all right, bro. I was on.
So oh, look, shit, bro. About it, we get it.
Bring your ass.
I'm saying, bro, it's been 30 minutes, bro. Come on, bro.
You want to be like the Akatsuki so bad, I'm gonna treat you like one.
There's no way in hell it take that long to set up a tripod and some old shit.
Fucking tripod.
This nigga in here cleaning the damn house. That's what he doing. I already know what he about to do.
He in there beating his dick. That's what he.
He in there trying to squeeze one out. You sick fuck.
I didn't know my voice was that caressing, my boy.
Nah, bro. Discord be doing miracles. It sound good in here.
It do, though. Ain't a lot.
But nah, first subject.
I don't think nobody me on say.
How I sprained my ankle. That's what we about to get into, bro.
You sprained your ankle?
Yeah, because I don't think I really gave the full story. So
you didn't, but you know.
Me and my boy Fred, bro, that man should be in here. About to bomb this hill, right? You know where the three banks is, bro? Where, like, the McDonald's area is, bro? And then you go down that hill where they just built that skate park yet, if you know what I'm talking about. You be in the borough, so you just, do know.
Nigga, they not just build that shit.
It's fairly new, you know what I'm saying? But
it look new, though.
Yeah. So we go down that damn hill, bro. And bro was like, you might want to drop the speed, bro. I was like, fuck it, I'm not dropping no speed. I dropped a little speed, bro. We go down that motherfucker, you know what I'm saying, bruh. First, I'm like, okay, we hitting this damn bitch, bruh. Then the speed start picking up, bruh.
Oh, you chose to be ignorant, nigga.
Bruh.
You asked for your ankle to be the way it fucking is. Your ankle not supposed to be this way. You said, fuck it, I'm going to do that shit. And they said, all right, got something for your ass. Karma punched you in your mother's dog. You got a sock in your shit. Karma socked you in your mouth.
But you can't sit here and lie to me, though, bro.
Cripple, nigga.
It was worth it. It was worth it, bro. You know what I'm saying?
It was worth it,
bro. It was worth the experience.
Hey, Quez, Hey, Quez, let's go hoop somewhere. Let's go hoop.
I can do that. I can walk on my ankle now, bro. That's all I need. I can't do all that spiffy shit, but I can do something. You feel me? But look, bro.
Let's go hiking.
I can do that. I can't run. Never mind. That wouldn't even be no good idea, bro. I ain't gonna lie to you. It wouldn't be no good idea. That's bullshit. So, coming down the hill, you know what I'm saying? That motherfucker went like this. He was like, I was like, oh my God, this junk about to start wobbling, bro. And you know, every skating video, once the war start wobbling, like, you gotta have some perfect, damn near perfect control just to get that bitch stabilized. That bitch going like
you
that.
You know, I used to watch the motherfucking parkour videos.
Yeah, bruh. This motherfucker started. He was like this. Next thing you know, I felt that jump zag. I said, oh, nah, bruh. I jumped off that bitch, right? And I'm already in my mind. I said, we going fast. I'm about to have to full sprint. Hot off. I'm going. Sprint now. I made it. This nigga Fred, the board, I hit Fred board, and he had to jump off. He told some, oh, my back. My fucking back, you like to kill me, nigga. I'm like, bro, you know I'm in here laughing, bro. I'm in here weak. He talks, ah, my back. Because you know, Fred got in that car accident. That nigga ain't never been the same. So.
Yeah.
This thing you know.
I ain't know that, but now I know.
But this thing you know, I'm just like, all right, bro. We sitting there taking a minute. I'm recollecting myself because we almost died. We had our shirts off, nigga, so we would have failed. We would have got road rash, bro. You know that niggas would have had that big scar going up his back that would have been burning and stinging days, bro. Would have turned to a big scab. We won't try to let it happen. I take the sprain over that road rash, not going to lie to you, bro. So next thing you know, boom, get back on the board. Fred is still down. Okay, he talking about this damn bad. I'm like, nigga, we got to go, bro. We got to go. Like, it's almost time. Like, it's already wanting some change, bro. I ain't getting in the house till like 2:00. It's like wanting some change. I'm like, nigga, I got to go. I'm getting in trouble. I got to go. Next thing you know, boom, turn around. I see Fred still on that bullshit. I hop off the board, right? Because I'm like, I'm about to go encourage this nigga to hairy his ass up. Hot off the board, ankle said. Smack. I said, oh my God. I'm in there. That shit hurt, nigga. Bruh. That shit was wild, bruh. I had a long board my way home. That adrenaline what got me home, bruh. And then we had a walk the rest of the way after we dropped Fred longboards off at his house. Got chewed out.
So you got chewed out for coming home late?
Yeah. Even though my ankle was twisted the fuck. That shit was wild.
Let me ask you a question.
Yeah.
Whose idea was it to longboard in the middle of the road past midnight?
Mine's. I take full accountability for that one.
What dumbass want a longboard at 1 a.m.?
Bro, it essentially started at like 9 to 10 o'clock because I had some other plans in mind. Think about that, bro. I had way other plans. My plans for that night was supposed to go very differently than what they did. What did my music stop?
This nigga wanted some coochie, huh?
Bro, you can't understand. Nah, bro. Yeah, I mean, maybe.
It was, is that the other C word, bro? What the fuck?
Huh?
That's the other C word,
motherfucker. I ain't say that. I was saying you can't say that because you never know who's watching. But yeah, like I was saying though, whole time getting it, man, bro. Night's supposed to go way different, bro. Then it is on wild, bro. So what, niggas? This nigga's Hazen still ain't in here. It's about to be 2:00, nigga.
What do you say?
Huh?
He said what?
Hazen ain't say nothing.
He just muted us. He said something, Negro.
I can't even hear that bullshit. Let me turn my mic, my headphones up. Cause my shit on like 20.
I hear you guys, Hazen, but get your ass in here, bro. Got your camera on, nigga.
What I'm you saying, doing? Bro, you didn't even have to have no spiffy ass setup, bro. This is the first one.
He was trying to find what?
How the fuck you hear him?
He said he's trying to find his ring light. Can't hear him.
You can't hear him?
You can't or you can?
I can't, like, it's, I do have music on, bro, but it's like I can't hear him like that, you know what I'm saying?
But you can hear me?
Yeah, I know he talking, bro, but I can't hear him. That's what I'm saying.
But can you hear me? The fuck?
The fuck? There we go. What's good, slim bitch?
I was confused because, like, the screen switched up crazy.
That nigga said,
China, how you wrote to the camera on your phone?
He just really asked that bullshit, bruh. How you rotate the camera on your phone? Do you not have an iPhone, bruh?
Yes, but I'm saying, like, Facebook, I know people, you gotta flick your phone.
Bruh, no, you just gotta turn that bitch, I guess, bruh. How you do it, Bryce?
You gotta go to the little orient. It got a little lock with a little arrow going around and shit.
Oh, word.
Just take that. Hold just time. Put that motherfucker.
Hey. Make sure that motherfucker white. That nigga Chris. That big A Chris.
That nigga Chris. That's a sexy name. I bet Chris fine as that lane.
Yeah, he is spinning, bro. Fat ass butt. Bro, look, bro. We got all the motherfuckers in here today, right now. In the bed.
Yeah, we do.
We got all the motherfuckers. Bro, I can change my damn stuff. I ain't know that. Cause on the computer they got the motherfucking shit where you can put it either in the grid or put it on a focus where it's only focused on one person at a time.
Boom.
Are you talking about with somebody talk that shit automatically goes to that shit?
I would hope so. It's only been on Bryce for, yeah, because it's definitely not switching the minds. Like, what the fuck? That shit gay. Yeah, we just keep it like this then. Fuck it.
Who are you talking about? Manga's video or some shit. I forgot.
You said, what, Manga's?
Yeah, they were texting the group chat talking about a motherfucking Manga's video.
Fucking Most Deaf, you're not lying.
That boy Hazeem told me about that shit. We ain't never do that shit, boy.
We'll post to, but what happened was Quiz said he had to buy it on the PC.
No. I said, yeah, bro, and I was going to do that, bro. But then you said, bro, Lando said he ain't even do shit. So I was just like, all right, fuck it. We going to play Call of Duty then.
Why'd you download that motherfucker free on PlayStation?
It's for free on PlayStation?
Duh, nigga. She been off like a month.
What the fuck?
I can put it on my damn PC, bro. Fuck it.
I thought that nigga put on the work clothes.
I'm about to say it's only $5, bro.
Yeah, that shit free on PlayStation. I think it's more enjoyable, you ask me shit.
I'd be damned if I do that shit on PlayStation. I can just do it on my PC.
You funny or something, bitch? Fuck you, ain't a PC. Put it on for the crash every time, every day, every night.
You ain't shit, bitch.
I might not be.
I gotta have some different tunes in this bitch, man. Damn.
Your next subject.
Next subject. Hey, we was going. Damn.
Yes, teacher.
Fuck. All right.
Yes.
All right. So look, bro. Basically, what I'm saying, we about to get into next. How was y'all niggas' day, bro? That's how we gotta set this bitch up. Hazeem, turn your shit, man.
Fuck.
Hazeem, turn your shit, bro.
I don't give no fucks about y'all day.
Bro, you don't give a fuck about your day, but the viewers give a fuck about our day, bro. Come on, man. You being mad.
I said, I don't give a fuck about your day, nigga. Man, I don't give a fuck about your day.
Fuck you, bitch.
Hey, white.
You trick ass bitch. Bruh, so how was your day, Diggy?
What you do, Diggy?
What you do today? How's ain't having technical difficulties like a motherfucker?
Hey, look. First thing I did.
What's up, man?
I woke up to a screenshot. Hey, man, what the fuck? So I text her. I'm like, who this? She like, oh, put it up to the girls group chat. I'm like, cool, whatever. I was sleeping, so I didn't really get no fuck. I texted later, and I kind of peeped what the screenshot really was. Bitch was texting a nigga. This bitch on stuck on her ex. Bro got a whole ass child to worry about. She's still
that nigga don't give a fuck about you all the time.
Motherfucker got a baby in his lap talking to 16-year-olds. Get a life.
Nah, that's kind of, that's weird, bro. I ain't gonna lie.
You, this nigga taking care of a life.
Not even that, bro. That nigga ain't even ready to take care of a life, bro. Not let alone somebody else, child. Bro, listen.
I'm gonna take his baby and sling that bitch.
Hey, yo, bro. Chill, bro. You can hear Hazeem.
Yeah, and I stand that thing.
Bro, you can hear Hazeem, bro.
No, I stand.
Bro, you can hear Hazeem. Nigga, can anybody hear me?
Yes.
Oh. But nah, like I was saying though, yeah, we can get into that bitch. But how y'all feel about what you feel like the age gap should be for motherfuckers dating, bro?
I say by like 2-3 years.
Yeah, 2-3 years.
Two, three years. Yeah, that's
except for when, except for when it's to the extent where you like, say you like 16, your boyfriend 19, in college, and you just becoming a sophomore, let alone a junior. I don't know.
Nah, that I say that shit weird. Low key, bro. I say, bro, it started getting to that weird range, bro. When you hit college, right? And you talking to high school bitches, you know what I'm saying? If they not no, like, no senior, you borderline fucking up when you hitting
juniors. You sick as hell.
You borderline hitting, you know what I'm saying? Exactly. That shit weird as fuck when you hitting junior, you know what I'm saying?
Right.
Senior, eh. But I feel like you in college, bro, you should be at least talking to college hoes, bro. That's just a fact.
I'm saying, on top of the fact, it be motherfucking seniors trying to strike on freshmen.
It's
like, what you?
I mean, technically, that is in the age group, bro, but you think about that, bro. That's down there 40
years.
I mean,
think about, no, you, at the same time, a bitch would be 14, bro, would be 18. You feel what I'm saying? That bitch, she just got her first period 2 years ago.
No cap. I'll look at it. No cap. But then again, bro, hey, yo, Bryce, you telling me it's not a freshman with the fat ass, bro? This bitch got the body like Meg. Cause that's how they build them nowadays, bro. They got more body than they do mine. Yeah, that's what I'm saying. That's exactly what I was about to say. They got more body than they mine right now. But that's what older niggas tend to go to, where struggling niggas. I ain't gonna say older niggas. We ain't gonna sit here and put myself in that down category. But that's what struggling niggas usually go to, bro. They motherfuckers, they be going to these bitch. What the fuck you about to do, bro? Oh.
Me?
Yeah, I thought you had a damn flame throw out this bitch. But that's what struggling niggas do. What is Hazeem got going on, bro? This nigga. The fuck is man doing, bro? But nah, bro. That's what the struggling niggas usually do, bro. They go toward, they gravitate toward the younger crowd because they feel like it's easier for them, bro.
And sometimes, and y'all, you be embarrassed as fuck. You try to struggle a younger bitch, and she embarrassed her ass. She start doing some
other
shit.
You gotta kill that bitch.
Oh God!
Kill that bitch. That's all you can do. Cause you go out. If you go out bad like that, then nigga, you's a lame. You ain't not even a lame. You borderline a ped. Oh, foul. Ooh, Quest. Yes, sir. You already know it. Now, she be inside this bitch with the fucking stream today. Podcast one. No sleep podcast. They said my stream must stay.
Shit. Fuck.
What's wrong with you, nigga?
What nigga, the that, fuck?
That nigga better busting nuts.
My fault.
Bro, what you do, bro?
Faces,
yeah, bro. What the hell you doing, bro? But, all right, bro. Chris, how your day been, bro?
You feel what I'm saying?
My shit been cool. I fucking woke up, brushed my teeth, fucking went outside for a little bit, played a game. Goddamn.
Chill ass.
Really, that's how.
Hey, so Christian, bro. Hell yeah. Chris had a chill ass Saturday. It's Saturday, right? Yeah, Saturday. Chill ass Saturday, bro.
Yeah.
Hazeem speak, bitch. Y'all hear Hazeem?
Yeah.
Hey, just leave and join right back.
Yeah, I'm gonna leave and join right back. That shit had been retarded.
This fool told me to leave.
I know. I can't. I left and came back. You goofy ass.
You hear Hazino?
Yeah, I can hear Hazino.
Hey, when we getting back in that boxing shit, man?
Bruh, I just told Juwan to get my gloves back. So I'm getting into it. I got my. I'm glad you said that. Boxing. Lord, I can't hear Bryce now, bro. What the fuck? Bryce, leave, bro. How's it you say something, bro? This is my shit going on. What the fuck?
Yo.
Yo, I can't hear Hazine again. I'm going to leave and come back.
Yeah, what the fuck your shit on, bro? This is you.
It can't be me. Maybe it's when I do the pop-out shit. Yo.
This nigga should stay on this.
I think it's when I do the damn pop-out shit, it start fucking up. Say my everybody's talk.
Yo.
All right, yeah, that shit working now. I'm just not going to do this. They're going to have to see Bree Candace in the corner. I don't care. I'm a cultured man.
You're going to have to see what in the corner?
Bree Candace. That's a beautiful big bitch.
Oh.
Yeah. I'm in Discords for a reason. You know what I'm saying? We all benefiting out of this bitch. How's it, bro? How was your day, bro? Be a dog?
It was straight, you know? Same old, same old.
Same old shit, just a different day. Trying to hustle hard, get the pay.
Yeah, got me a motherfucking rainbow shark.
The fuck is that, bro? You talking about your computer?
No fish, man. I wish I got it.
Oh, that come tomorrow, right?
Got some bad news, man.
What, you ain't getting that bitch no more? You got evicted?
No, man. I went to that bitch, man. She told me since I ain't had shit in my name, I couldn't get it.
Who said that? Rent?
Fucking Aaron's, bro.
Aaron's? Ah, man, I would have been mad, low-key.
And they had the best ones. They had fucking, they had Skytet, all that shit. This shit, bro, I'm telling you.
Whole time.
I'm talking about they had, man, if you seen it, bro. You seen the picture, though.
Yeah.
Goddamn.
I'm sorry. That's what you got to do, bro. Just go ahead and commit Sobuku, bro. Hit that backflip off your apartment roof and shoot yourself in the head at the same damn time, bro. While you midair. And let your body drop. Bro, I'm telling you. That's the damn backflip. Hell yeah.
Waddle.
Now, you jump out the roof, bro. You jump out. You jump off the damn roof with a sawed off shotgun and just blow your shit midair.
I'm starting to believe y'all are very suicidal.
We ain't, bro. Come on,
guys. Can I get 30 for y'all real quick?
What?
Damn.
Let nigga get 30 real quick.
Go ahead, get 30, Bryce. Go ahead, get 30, nigga. He know he been. He been. Yo. Yo, get 30, yeah. Nigga. Yes, sir.
Get sturdy, nigga. That big ass chair.
I'm saying that.
I'm for real, bro. He got
a fucking kitchen chair in his damn room, bro. Come on, get sturdy, nigga. Hurry up, bro, so we can move on to our next subject. Get sturdy, come on, bro. Get sturdy, man. Get sturdy.
Hey, Bryce, need to get sturdy again. I can't even say I'm get sturdy in your mom because I feel for your mom. All right, what I'm gonna say is, I'm gonna get sturdy in you.
What the fuck, man? What? Come on, bro.
Come on. He said I'm gonna get sturdy in you. Is he about to start tooting ass like that man fucking Speed?
Nah, he about. Now you about to get sturdy in a bit. Y'all get sturdy, bro.
Somebody.
Get sturdy, Bryce. Get sturdy, nigga. Yeah. That's the littest podcast you'll ever be in, bro. You ain't never been in nothing like this, bro. Go ahead. Get sturdy. Uh-huh.
Hey,
Oh yeah. He said he throwing the bitches off. I mean, he took the bitches off. Yeah, he about to piss everybody off in the house with all the damn jumping he doing. That boy got sturdy. Hey. Bro, you know the whole time we couldn't hear your music, bro, because that shit was just clipping the damn... it was clipping the whole time. Yeah, bro, it was clipping the whole time. Bro, you can't play that shit.
Y'all can just add the
whole time.
That shit don't get copyrighted?
Nah, bro, I'm saying, like, the music was too loud, bro, so it was maxing out the mic, nigga, so we couldn't hear it.
Oh, like, it was too loud?
Fucking hell, bro, it's a dub now, bro. Come on. Come back to the damn cool kids corner.
Yeah, yeah, man, you can't get sturdy no more. That shit got a pipe
in it. You said what?
You good now, right?
Yeah, you good, bro. I told you, it was just that bullshit. Well, yeah, bro. My day, bro, let me tell you what my day consisted of, bro. I was at work, busting ass, per usual, bro. You know how it goes, bro, up in the damn, bro, man. I'm out here trying to make a chit, trying to make some bread, bro, so I can cut this cheese. So, look, bro, up in this bitch at work, ankle started bothering me. I'm like, fuck, I'm ready to go home, bro. This shit just starting to get serious, bro. I'm feeling like Hazeen in the fucking mix. You feel me, bro? My fucking shit hurt. So, look, bro, I'm telling you, bro, this thing, though, bro, got off work. Pretty good day. That's all, bro. I've been at work all day, bro. Just busting my ass, bro. Trying to make a dollar. But back to what Christian said, bro. When we getting back into this box and stuff, bro. I got my wraps now. I got wraps now. My own wraps. I got my motherfucking mouth guard. Because, you know, this is a boxer gym, it goes, bro. We got to get back on our stuff, bro. Another thing. Want to tell my nigga Christian, bro. We going to start doing a lot of more shit, bro. Once I get my damn car, bro. You know what I'm saying, bro? We going to, We'll start come scooping your ass, bro. I know your ass be bored, man. I be bored. I be bored, nigga. So I know you be bored.
Speaking of, hey, look.
Yeah.
My fault for cutting off. Guess who back, goddamn?
Who?
Chris. Jordan, man. He back.
Jordan? Yeah, I know. I seen that shit.
Yeah, he back from Africa, boy.
What the hell he at,
right? He at his crew.
But yeah, bro. We're going to get into that joint, bro. My college money's supposed to be coming in next month, so I'm going to give me a call with that. So we whipping, bro. Big whipping. Big W's in the chat. Big W's in the chat. We about to get into it, bro. We about to be doing shit, bro. All the videos, all the exclusives, bro. The big, big win shit, bro.
Big W, bitch!
Feel me? Big Dubs. Shit, bro. Well, we moving on right into our first motherfucking topic, to our next motherfucking topic, bruh. I had to cut that nigga Jimmy Lee hair today, bruh. That nigga said he wanted the shit shaved off. He wanted the damn ball, bruh. He wanted the damn first grade cut, bruh. And I skinned it. You said
hold
what,
on,
bruh?
Hold on.
Who
the fuck up? This is a conversation I need to hear.
Bruh. Yes, sir. You said what, Bryce?
Using that motherfucker peeling skin,
bruh. Bruh. Hey, that joint, bruh, that's all I could think about, bruh, when I was doing that joint. It was talking about, man, cut it bald, man.
Hey, hold on. Damn, nigga.
Hello? Hey, you said if I don't get the bottom of my balls, but one of my bros, I'm gonna die. That's what you said, Doc. Y'all boys heard it yourself, right?
Damn, bro. I see you in hell, pal.
Y'all boys. You said specifically Q to Don.
Man, Doc. Get the fuck out of here, bitch.
Okay, speaking of Jimmy fucking Lee.
Yeah, bro. The man, the myth, the legend, bro. It's crazy. Yeah, bro, wait a minute. I gotta get a perfect representation of this shit, bro, because you can't make this shit up, bro. So, look, bro, you know how you got the barber got your head, and he be having your head like, bro, I can't do it with that. Let me do it with this, bro.
like, basically,
he'll put your joint, bro, so he can just cut straight up, bro. Like, I had his joint like that, right? I'm doing Look, I'm doing that motherfucker like these, right? And yeah, bro, cause he wanted the ball, bro. He wanted his shit balled off, bro. And bro, look, bro, out here, bro, like, cause you know you gotta hold the skin up, bro, so you don't snag his shit. But what, bro?
That nigga in the hospital, I can make all the fucking jokes I want, so I'm sorry.
Hell yeah.
That nigga feeling good about you touching on his head like that.
Fucking dumb.
Jimmy in the hospital?
He was. He had pneumonia, bro. I was about to crease his ass up the other day. I ain't gonna lie.
Ain't
you can't say that
in
the same sentence as Jimmy
Lee.
I'm listening.
Like something wrong with your balls?
No, like, bruh. No, bruh. Pneumonia, bruh. It's where it's in your lungs, bruh. You sick, bro. Bitch. Bruh, look, bruh. I had, bruh, head like these, right? And tell me why when I let my hand up, bruh, his damn skin was stuck at the top of his shit, slowly unfolding down, bruh, like a fucking nutsack. I said, bruh, I got to get the fuck out of here. This shit was crazy. Bro, like, bro, shit look like a damn nutsack, bro. I had to skin brush it off, bro. It was crazy as fuck. That's an odd job, bro. I felt like a real barber for real, though, bro. But you know what I felt like, bro? You remember that day, bro, we was inside the barbershop, bro? And dude was like, fuck, bro, say. He was like, I'm about to get me some food, because I can. That nigga, bro. And your cousin was getting on his ass because he wanted his shit balled on too. He told him, if I would have cut anymore, I would have been cut that nigga's scalp.
Yes, yeah, who the fuck did he think he was,
bro? He thought he was that guy. That's what he felt like he was. Yeah, he thought he was that nigga. He
said, like, I give a fuck about this chair. I get up and get some food because I can't.
I'm saying, I was like, yo, bro, who nigga is this, bro? He trying to be a hot nigga inside the damn... The barbershop, like, you doing extra for what? Nobody cares.
Like, that nigga shit was completely pilled, and that nigga had the gall to get up out the chair, so he gonna go to the crib and finish it himself.
Like, what you gonna do, nigga? Put the fucking razor and the cream on that bitch? He wanted a damn spit shine. That's what he wanted.
See his reflection in the mirror. Like, bruh. He wanted. You know what I'm trying to say.
Hell yeah, basically, bruh. But nah, bro, and it's crazy because he would walk inside of there. This same dude that we talking about will go inside of there and talk about all the bitches that he get. Like, that nigga's not pushing fucking 70. Like, nigga, what bitches is you getting? You can't even get that bitch up at that age, bro. Nigga, meat can't even stay hard. The fuck is you fucking? Like,
that nigga meat damn near come on.
You said what, Bryce?
Nigga, me ain't even the meat no more,
bro. I'm saying, bro, he just got that shit he piss out of, man. That's just extra skin. He said it ain't nothing but some flesh. Hey, yo, bro. Nah, bro. Man, bro, this year is coming to a damn close, and it's coming to a close fast, bro. It's already about to be September. In fact, the fuck is the day?
It's a short fucking year, that's why. I mean, the year been short as hell. That's why, like...
I ain't gonna lie, it did, but the summer to me felt the longest, bro, even though niggas ain't do much.
I mean, the summer felt long because we ain't been in, like, real school for real.
I mean, I wasn't in school. I was out since January, bro.
Hey, quick question before we continue with this conversation. Quiz, why you got your crutches in the camera, man? Did you just get hurt?
Bro, I sprained my ankle 3 days ago. You want to hear for that?
Hell no.
Lord, bro. Yeah.
Nigga,
you had to
work through
that. Come
off a
longboard at 2 a.m. Yeah, we was on longboards at like 2 o'clock. Like, it wasn't even 2 o'clock, bitch. Fuck you. It was like more. It was 12 going on 1, and then we bombed this hill, jumped off. I was all right. Then I hopped back on the board and then jumped off.
Oh no, you called me late. It was late as a bitch. I was asleep.
It was like 11.
Bro, I don't fucking want.
It was.
Where at?
You called
where
me.
Where y'all at?
By the dog park. When I called Bryce, I was by the dog park, bro. We haven't even made it to sheets yet. That's y'all how I know for a fact it was.
We need to feel like me to the state park and goddamn Durham, bro. They don't be.
Yeah, let me see when I called your whole ass.
But you ain't gonna be able to find it, dummy.
Dami, what are you geeking for? Dami, yes, you can. All you gotta do is go to the
This man.
Hey, who y'all think gonna win that fight tomorrow?
Tyron Woodley. If he don't,
Tyron sound like he won it the most, man.
Bro, if he don't, I'm not watching Boston anymore.
Yeah. Jay Paul win that. I swear to God, I'm thinking everybody taking the guy.
Yeah,
I got Logan Paul.
Bitch, he don't fight. Yo, you fucking dumb. Yo, it's Jake and Tyron Woodley, bro. You see how he wanted to go against the odds so bad, bro?
Ain't that the nigga that I whooped on you with in UFC 3?
Bro, what, bro? When did you know? Whoa, bro. Hold on. Bro, no, bro. When did you, bro? When was you winning? When was you ever winning in UFC, bro? Last time I remember, bitch, I was fucking you up.
Every time we played, bitch.
Bro, you crazy, bro. What was I about to go check, bro? You made me lose track. Yeah, right.
Wax your fucking skin.
Yeah, right.
Man, nah, though. If I would have bet this time, I would have got some money, man.
Hold on. Time.
Niggas had bet up on fucking the Logan versus fucking Mayweather fight. Niggas kept their money, so I was good out of that.
Bro, yeah, Bryce, it was 11:07, bro.
How you find that shit? You just made that shit up.
No, bro, all you got to do is go to your call history, bro.
Yeah, I'd be on the phone at all, do you?
What are you talking about, bro? I do, bro, but I just know what day it was. It was Thursday.
Couldn't find that shit if I wanted to.
Bro, it's because you be out here fucking whoring around, man. Fucking man whore.
What the fuck you say when we started this, bro?
Bro, you are. It's certain stuff that we can't say. I apologize, bro. I apologize, but it's not like it was the truth. Buddy. You said what? Yeah. Bro, what's huh?
Running my mouth.
Calm down, bro. Cause you, that shit, the shit that you be saying, bro, you can't be saying, bro.
Hey, yo, Quiz, bro.
No.
You ever relate to smacking down his sister?
Bro, you about to get muted, bro.
Hey, it's just something I
want to
know.
You said what? Can I ever relate to what, bro?
With niggas smacking down his sister.
How would you feel, bro? Nah, we got to get ideas. Not even ideas, bro. We got to get thoughts on that one, bro. Bro, how would you feel, bro?
What is it?
Bro, Hazeem, let's talk about how we can't see nothing but your damn teeth in the camera, bro.
Hey, bitch, I been at work, getting black in the sun.
Yeah, bro.
And I turn off the lights.
Yeah, I guess. But nah, bro.
My shorty in here trying to sleep, so you know what I'm saying? Everybody else in the crib knocked out.
Fuck all that, bro. What the fuck? How would you feel, right? If you and your homeboy, chilling, right? And he said he about to be back for third. Like, he about to go get some water, right? Y'all outside hooping, right? And then next thing up, bro. You go.
In there smacking your
sister's
cheeks.
That nigga in there smacking. No, he's smacking his sister, bro.
What the fuck?
Hey, bro, that nigga can't be my friend no more.
Nah, look. Let me put it in a better perspective for you. So look, say you outside hooping, it's pushing 90 degrees, man, and you hooping about an hour. So motherfuckers say, hey, I'm about to go get some water. It's hot as a bitch. You know, cool. You feel what I'm saying? You outside just shooting around and shit, waiting. Say about 15 minutes go by, and you like, where the fuck these niggas at? So out of the kindness of your heart, you decide to go check on them. You feel what I'm saying? You go inside, and you hear a shh. Up the foot. So, you know what I'm saying? You think it's a little game. So, like, where may they be? Like a little kid trying to play hide and go seek. So, like, where may they be at? So you peep the corner, and you see, like, your homeboy ass out, dick out on his sister, smacking at me. Got it slab on her back.
Nigga, I'm going home, call it a day.
Call it a day. I ain't gonna lie, bro.
The fuck out of you.
I ain't gonna.
Hold up. This from hearing that, I'm gonna be real with you. I'm gonna be 100% honest. That sound like some shit that a nigga would have to, like, just think about life. Man. Like, yo, you really in here smacking your damn sister down while we ball sweaty, nigga. We done hoop for an hour.
Bryce, didn't I say that? Bryce, didn't I say that?
balls sweaty as a fuck, smacking your sister down. Not no random bitch. Your sister down.
You know what I'm saying? Like, you know him. Hey, look, you watched her come up the womb.
Yeah,
I'm saying, bro. Nigga, but you not. Listen, you're not just...
I know some weird niggas. Like, listen. I be around some. Well, I ain't gonna say I be around. I know some weird niggas. Like, I be in the party with some niggas, and they brought up something similar to this, and then I seen something also on Instagram. I'm pretty sure them niggas would be like, bro, when you gonna let me get that too? Like, bitch, no. You just watch this nigga smack his own sister.
Hell like, yeah, I'd be disgusted.
That
I ain't
shit weird.
Bro. I ain't
even... motherfucker.
Like, did y'all see that shit on Instagram where the dude was like, shit, if your daughter, if you walk in, your daughter end up getting trained on by the whole football team, what you gonna do? And he said, shit, we just gonna fucking tag team them together. Okay. He was like, they was like, what? Like,
hell yeah,
we gonna be throwing ass together, shit. They gotta fuck her and me. I was like, oh, hell no. Nah.
He tweet.
Ain't buddy tweet, bro. Nah,
ain't
bro.
That when niggas like, you be like, they be like, would you rather have a gay son? Oh, now a gay son or a dot daughter? They be like, it's free here regardless. Yeah, the same thing.
Fuck, I've never heard of this shit, bro.
That's not the same thing?
Nah, bro. I said, nah, you fucking tweet, G. Man, nah, bro, but hell no.
Damn free head.
You sick as fuck if you look at your son and your daughter that way. You don't deserve to have kids, you sick bitch.
It's like, motherfucker, like, you seen the motherfucker come out the womb, and the first thing that comes to your mind is, oh, yeah, I'm gonna hit that one day.
Oh, Tom. Man, fuck that, bro. How y'all niggas feel about this damn second wave of COVID, man?
I ain't gonna lie, bro. If I'm meant to get it, I'm meant to get it. If I'm not, I'm not. That shit already out in the universe,
bro.
Huh?
That's what I'm saying, bro. That's what I said, bro. But I'm talking about, like, just shutting down the shit and all this stuff. And shit may be mandatory to get that damn vaccination.
That damn shit is the only thing I'm getting paid now. So, like,
going for
quarantine, I wouldn't be motivated to try and even get paid. But shit, the vaccination shit, that shit is dead. I'm not getting it.
Bro, you know, they might start forcing motherfuckers to be like, yo, bro, you gotta take this shit.
Yeah. Until motherfuckers look like the next I Am Legend. And what?
Well, yeah. I was about to say, I knew Hazen shit was fucked up. He was sitting there in the corner like these the whole damn time. Bro, but nah, bro. I mean, bro, I don't know. I'm not worried about the damn shit itself, bro. I'm just worried about the way shit about to turn. You know what I'm saying, bro? Like, as in what nigga, how much niggas gonna be able to get out, bro? Because if I can't get out, at least get no ass, bro. Nah. Killing myself.
That's straight up. It's about time to try and juggle Mitri from her nigga.
Damn, you out here name dropping, you sick bitch. I told you about this shit.
Bitch, I forgot it was even on stream the whole time.
Nigga.
The whole time, bitch, I forgot. Damn.
Bruh. Why? You talking about, damn, nigga, like, who we talking about, bruh? You talking about me or you, nigga?
I'm talking about you.
Bruh, no, bruh. I'm gonna go ahead and tell you one thing, bruh. Like, once you live together, bruh, that shit is, that's OD. You know what I'm saying, bruh? I don't even think I could, to be honest with you, I know me. I don't even think I could finesse that for real, bruh. These niggas stay together. It ain't like you could just walk up in that bitch. And it's crazy that you said this is Hazen Lee, because this nigga fucking hate that bitch.
For real?
Yeah, that nigga Hazen can't stand her ass, bruh.
Yeah, I'm saying, like, yeah, her sister, she hold girls now. That shit really dead.
Yeah, that shit dead. You ain't smart. Look, bitch.
I'm getting ass two ways. Hey, I'm getting ass two ways. You know what I'm saying? Like Kodak said, fucking on Dockerman's love. But other than that,
it's fucking stupid. Man, bro, how school been treating y'all boys, man?
Like hell, but I'm in this motherfucker taking Chinese, goddamn. Shit.
Christian, high school treating you, bitch?
I fucking hate it.
Bro, you go to Goldsboro. You still go to Goldsboro, right?
Yeah.
Bro, what's different now, bro? Like, can y'all niggas get out of the class at least, bro? Can you even skip
class?
Yeah,
that shit deep as fuck. School deep as fuck, bro.
Bro, so it basically ain't nothing changed, bro.
you just gotta wear masks, goddamn it.
See, but the thing is, bro, that's how I felt like shit. Like, bro, let's be real, bro. When motherfuckers was going, I feel like North Carolina not getting hit. But I mean, I feel like it is, but I feel like Goldsboro not getting hit like every place else, bro. Small ass Goldsboro, bro. They was gonna nuke Goldsboro at one point in time. You ain't know about that?
Yeah.
They was gonna fuck around and drop bomb straight on Goldsboro. They was about to blow this bitch clean off the map.
I'd be bad for my mama calling me.
Alright, bro.
They were trying to wipe this motherfucker off existence, nigga.
Yeah, they was about to smooth wipe this shit off the damn face of the earth, man. It was happening around 2012, bro.
Alright, yeah. I mean, 2012 was when everybody was going through all that bullshit. And then, yeah. Motherfuckers, I remember church with the Roman calendar, and motherfuckers was trying to say that the world was going to end.
They were like, the world is ending. It's 2012. Like, nigga.
Yeah, my mom said the same shit was in 2002. She said, she remember it being like, I think she said, no, 2002. But 2000, mom said she remember it being 1992, the high school, go to her mom. They was out of church telling every fucking body that it hit 12 o'clock, year 2000, that motherfucker was gonna blow.
Hell yeah. Man, bruh. What you got planned for, bro, what grade you in right now, bro? I forgot.
Huh?
Huh?
10th.
10th grade? Yo ass capping like shit, but we ain't gonna let that. We gonna let that slide, bruh. Shit. The fuck was I gonna say, bruh?
I don't even know, bruh.
I don't even know what the fuck niggas about to say, man. Man, bruh. Damn, bruh. This was a good ass fucking little run, you feel me? You fuck.
Yeah, fuck.
Bro, nah, I need to get video ideas, bro. Was you coming back to YouTube, nigga?
I really become like, nigga, I recorded, I probably got about 2 hours of footage from the first day.
What, school?
Yeah.
They let you do that shit? Nah, I feel like, nah, I don't feel like they let your ass do that shit. I know you, bro. I know how your ass get down. You said what?
I wasn't really wilding.
Nah, I remember back when your ass really was wilding and shit.
Yeah.
Niggas are doing the most.
Like, you know, little break periods. Then we got a free period for like, I think like 45 minutes.
Y'all niggas in a free period? How many fucking, damn, what's that shit called now?
What, classes, nigga?
Yeah, nah, but it was like how many cores or some shit. I think that's what they used to call this. I forgot what the fuck it was, bro.
It's four. Oh, semesters or quarters?
Nah, like, not quarters, like fucking classes you got in a day.
Oh, four.
Bro, can
I put it this way. Say you got a college credit already in a class that they gave you.
Yeah.
You could take a free period for that class. Instead of having to do that class, because you already got a college credit, so you won't need it.
Facts. Bro, how you enjoying high school, bro, so far, bro? How long y'all been back?
3 days.
Why 3 days? Nigga, it's the weekend. What day y'all come back?
Started Wednesday. Wednesday, Thursday, Friday.
Oh, shit. Three. I about to say, this could be my third week in school. How the bitch? Yeah, because we started, our first day was only a day. Then we had a solid week, and then this week gonna come up. How that shit been treating you, my boy?
Well, waking up at 5:45, that shit not it at all.
Hell yeah.
No, but I gotta get home. Maybe hoop, or at least have some time to chill. But by the time I'm done all my work and shit, I be ready to kill.
Bro, I ain't gonna lie. That's how it would be for me, bro. I'm not used to getting back up, bro. Cause you know, even when we was going to school, niggas was getting up. Well, I get up okay. Around the same time, but that shit is kicking my ass, bro. I'm used to stand up. Cause I had basically this whole year, I ain't did shit. So You just be up. You just like, man, I'll be about to fall asleep in class. You can't do that shit in college, bro. But hopefully this week could be different because we're going to be doing more. I doubt it's going to be like hands-on shit. Huh?
You in person, right?
Yeah.
That shit dope.
I about to say, nigga, we in the garage, bro. We got no choice but to be in person.
Oh, yeah.
Well, I said, if we not in person, then, bro, I might as well just fucking drop out. Nah, that's a dummy move, bro. I would have to owe money out the ass if I did that. But then it would fuck up my financial aid, and then I wouldn't be able to go back to school. That's one thing. If you ever get in college, bro, you better have your mind made up, bitch.
That's what I'm saying. Like, shit, when I was fucking, I feel like if I would have took you too serious to a point, I feel like if I would have actually did something, I'm not saying it's too late, but shit, if I would have actually did something on my phone, I'd probably drop out next year.
Hell, bro. I'm trying to get to that damn point, bro. It's just my time management skills are fucking doo-doo, bro. Y'all see what times my damn streams be. I mean, this I can't help. I can't help what time my streams, because this is like the only free time I get, bro. But time management.
You know what I'm saying? Get a little stream name and shit.
You know? You said what, bro?
Stream name came in clutch. Makes sense, you know?
Hell yeah. Because I can actually do this, like, for the free. You know what I'm saying? Get the people up in here, bro. Shout out to all my Twitch people, bro. And shit like that. We kind of got 40. What we at? 45 right now? We got 45 kind of fast, bro. So, fucks with that. You said what now?
I said it's dope as fuck, God.
I'm saying, bro. I wish it was, you know, 45 people. I ain't going to bash my people that be in this bitch because they cool as fuck. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
But hell yeah, I just want to follow. I like, bro, even if it was just like 10, 11 people a stream, nigga. You know what I'm saying, bro? Just for that. Fucking raw as fuck, bro. That shit would be raw as fuck. And then niggas could start doing shit like fucking regular meetups and shit. Hell, man. I'm just trying to build. That's all. I'm just trying to build, bro, so I can make do with life and chill and shit like that. You feel me? That's all I am, bro. Every nigga that know me know I'm one of the chillest people, bro. Until we get out and do some dumb ass shit. You know what I'm saying, bro? Even then, I'm still a chill person, bro. Put it on my tombstone, bitch. Chillest nigga on planet Earth.
You want
a
chillest nigga on your tombstone?
Yeah, bro. Whole time, bro.
My only question to you is, are you out your fucking...
Bro, what you mean, bro?
Motherfuckers gonna be like, damn. R.P. my nigga. What's the chillest person?
He was the coolest cat in the coldest set. Fuck you talking about?
But nobody gonna... Don't even get your hopes up for that fucking shit.
Hell nah, that shit ain't even gonna stick. Man, bro. Well, we gotta get back into this shit. Like, making videos and shit, bro. I haven't made a video, bro. I can't even, let me check, bro. When the last time I dropped a video, like, it's been fucking hella long.
I forgot about your backup channel, so I think you made that one gaming video.
Let me see.
But I mean, it was short as fuck. I don't know why you made it.
Bro, it was, bro, when you press for content, that's what you do. Bro, yeah, you God, bro.
Could have at least got somewhere in the fucking game, my boy.
What game, bro? That was it. That was the whole game, bro. We just did a random game. Yeah. That shit was ass. But
the game was you looking around a room for
It was supposed to be just a scary experience. My last video, like, video was Focus, bitch.
That bitch is not going to.
This motherfucker don't want to focus, damn it.
That was it's not right. Going to focus. I like it is, this.
Bro. It's going to focus, bro. It's going to focus, bro. Fuck that bitch. That was my last video anyways, bro. That one at the top. It was over a month ago. I know it's even longer on my gaming channel because that bitch just don't get love no more. We haven't dropped shit on the HSB channel. We actually recorded a video for the HSB channel. It was a group Q&A. And you know what happened? Somehow the damn audio got fucked up. That shit got me, kind of got me hot, bro. Damn, my last video, gaming video on the channel was 2 months ago. I was gonna record a video tonight. I got another video though. Video playing in the works right now. I want y'all to tell me how y'all feel about this bitch. Who the fuck is this? Oh, bro, but yeah. Video idea in the works. This shit sound fire as fuck. It sound fire as fuck, but it's toxic as hell when I come off with it. You know what I'm saying, bro? I'm calling up like a good group of my exes and tell them I want them back to see what their reaction is. That's a fire ass. What's up?
I'm on TikTok.
I do be on TikTok, but most of the shit that we be doing, bro, like, I be posting streams on TikTok and shit. They don't even be going. They be taking, like, muting my shit.
Nah, like, just take, like, probably, like, the funniest part of your clip, and you can pay probably $5, and they'll put it on random niggas for you pages, and you probably get, like, up to 10K views. Maybe $20.
You do that shit?
And say it attracts 10,000 niggas, and just, even if just 20% of them niggas are attracted to it, yeah, that's 2,000 niggas to your stream you got. And then growing your shit.
Hell yeah. Hell yeah. Man, bruh. Where is it?
I tried that shit. I uploaded the video to TikTok. Bitch, I had 0 followers. Now my video got 795 views.
I was about to say, because I mean, the clips that I did upload that they let keep up there, I'm about to check them right now. I haven't checked these shits in a brick. Let me see. I got 14 followers. I mean, it's something. But.
Is you going to buy this nigga how Zink say he was fucking with his trap bar? Motherfucker changed the outfit 3 times.
Only changed the hoodie.
Nah, you changed the damn outfit 3 times. You had a you had that damn robe on. You changed out the Akatsuki into some regular ass bullshit, and then you
I had a shirt on. I still got that shirt on.
You dirty bitch. And then you
fucking around with y'all, I broke my tripod. That's what happened.
That ain't messing with us. You just a dumbass.
No, bro. Listen, Well, I ain't break the tripod. I broke the piece that clamps on that hold the phone up.
Yeah.
So what happened was my phone died, and I tried to hear like get my charger. I kicked it over my phone, then it fell, and then next thing you know, I looked, the little piece that clumped the phone on snapped in half. I was,
yeah, but my views is like, I got 582 for one, 692 for another one, 647 for one, then 184 for this Dragon Ball video I did, because niggas won't fucking with it.
That's a TikTok?
Yeah.
That ain't bad at all.
Yeah, it's not. But,
man,
that's what I was dropping on top of.
What I'm doing when I'm editing.
Yeah.
Huh?
What blog?
Bro, I haven't touched no footage from my camera at all. I got, man, you know I was recording
big
everything.
Big vlog, the big vlog. You know what I'm talking about.
Yeah, big vlog. Coming soon, YouTube. YouTube niggas, if you looking
what
at this.
Big,
We can't say too much. It's they know though. If they pay attention to our instances, they know.
Hey,
they should seen it on our story.
Hey, Bryce, but you already know what it is though. The shit that you've been telling me to vlog, bro. That I told you I vlog, bro. That you were saying you should vlog.
How about this?
The con. Yeah,
that's it. Y'all been scamming niggas.
We ain't been scamming niggas. How we been scamming niggas?
Oh,
y'all some con artists.
Nigga, what? You know what I'm talking about, bro.
Ah, oh, shit.
You dumbass. You goofy.
If it's a vlog and I'm talking about the con, you should know.
Why would we record ourselves conning niggas, bro? You dumbass.
I swear to God.
I'm like, nigga, what? We about to get fucking Bobby Schmurder. They gonna be like, yeah, we got him. This is too easy.
I'm tripping.
Whole time. How you switching that bitch around like that? What happened?
What the fuck?
Nah, I had to turn my camera off and turn it back on because it's not turning on.
That bitch still don't work. Huh?
I was commenting on how unattractive you were. My
fuck you.
I can't.
What, Quiz? You can see me?
No. It's dots on my screen. Your shit is fucked. You said what, bro? That shit is still off.
That nigga got his fucking body.
You said that nigga got his body, bro?
Camera is.
Nah, yeah, that camera's fucked. Hey, Christian, bro, you been mighty quiet. Can't turn the fuck up, man.
He said what?
I said turn the fuck up.
Hey, look, Quiz, I got a question for you, bro.
What's up, bro?
You know how you doing that Twitch and YouTube shit, right?
Yeah.
How the fuck do I put this fucking, you know how you got, like, people you really fuck with, like, in real life, right?
Mm-hmm.
Like, do them niggas support that shit? Like, do they even tune in?
Man, fuck no, bro. And that's the problem.
What?
Ain't nobody, bro, no. I can't tell you a single nigga from the borough that been like, well, you know what? Except for you, Hazing, this nigga Bryce. You know, basically niggas in HSB. And,
Hold on, listen. What was the question?
The question was, and that's a good-ass question. He said, bro, you know how you doing this YouTube and stream shit, bro? He was like,
is niggas in the boroughs?
No, he said, do niggas in real life, practically, basically saying the borough, do these niggas support you? And I said, fuck no.
No, I'm going to tell you why, because I know this from a fact. You know, I was doing my music shit for a minute now.
Yeah.
So I'm going to explain this shit from a point of view that I witnessed off of both our point of view. You feel me? They weren't supporting Quiz when he first came into this shit.
Bruh, and you know how long I've been
and
doing
right
this
now,
joint?
They still ain't. But that's what's hey, going to But listen, I know that shit sound wrong as hell. But listen, that's what's going to make his come up even hard as hell. You want to know why? Yeah. He got a bunch of people that don't take no I put his eyes on him. But when that light shine on them, then they going to want to. They going to wish they did that shit.
Look
same
at what,
thing with me and my music, and my YouTube, and my stream and shit.
And
like,
we got one.
That's just how we all been.
Fast.
Anybody that's in HSB, that's just how we is. Like we don't get that type of attention. But
we got a primary.
We
got
people that can grasp that shit.
We got a prime example as well.
I'm glad they're running up because niggas really don't. Cause I say, I got on YouTube probably 150 subscribers. On my story, I get like 700 views. I was posting my business on my story for one. I fuck around and get like 500 views on the video and like 20 likes. Cause motherfuckers, they'll see your shit and they'll watch your shit, but they're not supporting you. They watch your shit from the shadows type shit.
Yeah, they watching you see if you can flop or not, bro.
They pretty much they printing your downfall. They wanna see what's gonna happen next, but they don't wanna support like say shit go good.
I see what you're saying.
You basically saying they watch your shit, but they don't watch your shit. They like
outside.
A nigga that sit in the shadows and stop you.
Yeah, it's a nigga outside really looking in. Out. Like, bro, like I said, bro, outside niggas looking in, bro, waiting to see for you to flop.
Bro, oh yeah, I watch your shit. You know what I'm saying? I remember being the same class, all the other shit. Your shit flop. They gonna be the first motherfuckers talking about how horrible your shit was
and how much of a fuck up you is. Like,
watching that shit early.
And the crazy,
that's for sure.
And the crazy thing about it is, you got a prime example, bro. Adrian K, you seen how every nigga in Goldsboro was talking about that motherfucking shit, bro. When he was popping out the nigga schools, bro. Be like, hey, yo, bro, you spelled this wrong. Nigga came to Goldsboro. He said, you spelled this wrong, I can get a neck you, bro. Was out here smacking the dog shit out of niggas' heads, bro, because they was spelling Mississippi wrong and shit like that. And fucking handkerchief. Yeah. Like, nigga was getting the mad publicity, bro. Handkerchief.
You said handkerchief, man.
Bro, you know what I mean, whore. Like, bro, basically, nigga was getting mad publicity for all this joint, bro. Nigga was just supporting him and all that, bro. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, that is true.
Like,
that
niggas
is
was
true.
Watching that nigga. And it depends
like,
on the person, too, bro.
Be real, you know, at that time, majority of Adrian followers was niggas he knew. They wasn't niggas around global.
Yeah,
now
yeah.
What popped Adrian off was this 4H shit. Like now he a global like person now.
Yeah,
niggas around the US know this shit. Nigga and they be like, bro, that's the 4H nigga. He make
50K, 100K a month type shit like that. And they like, damn, let me hit this nigga. But at that time zone, it was mainly niggas. Now, yeah, he got like almost like 6,000, 10,000 on YouTube now. Like, and yeah, that's now global, but most of those people came from his, but you know what I'm saying, 4-8 shit. Now, it goes for that, when that nigga was sitting at 2,000, that was all his fault.
But listen, it goes back, it's go back to what I was saying. Niggas in Goldsboro, half of the borough was hyping this shit up. Let's be real. Niggas was posting his videos on the story, bro. And not on the hating shit. Not on the hating shit. But still.
They want to have the borough. Say, it's a random nigga one nigga out of the 100. A lot of niggas fuck with that one nigga, but none of them fuck with you. If they fuck with him, and you say, yo, his shit wrong, they don't go fuck with it. But say, a nigga like me, and I know a nigga, he probably got like, he probably got a couple of followers. Don't fuck with him for real. He said, yo, my nigga just did this, he did that. Ain't nobody gonna go re-listen to that shit. Adrian knew a couple niggas like that. So they'd be like, hey, you're gonna fuck with that nigga shit, they gonna go do that. Just because they fuck with a person that was like giving him a shout out and shit.
That's how that shit worked, bro. To be honest with you, like, life is all about connections and the people that you know, if we being honest, bro. That's like, you can't get put on, bro. Networking. Like, that shit is rare.
Network, you good.
Cause that shit wild as fuck, bro. I seen how fast the nigga took off, bro. And that, like, that and being a female is the easiest way to take off in life, bro. Females got it easy.
That's a fact. That's why I was telling my girl. I said, fucking females got it made. When it come down to social media, y'all got it made for y'all. And I was telling her, I was like, man, she don't understand how fast she could blow up, bro.
And then this
like, females got it made for OnlyFans, fucking YouTube.
Yeah, and this new way,
what else? It doesn't matter, bro. The hub, it doesn't matter. Y'all can blow up in endless amount of ways.
This new way of niggas got new age is making money. Cut me off again, bitch, and see what happened to your fucking kneecaps. Damn, bitch, I've been trying to make a point, man. Damn. Let me get some damn time.
You cut me off. I went to talking.
Go ahead, bro. Go ahead. Fuck it. Go ahead, bro.
Like I was saying, like, you know what I'm saying? Niggas only got a couple handful of things that we really can blow up off of. And you know what I'm saying? It ain't the handful of stuff that females got.
Yeah, we got
it. It's either we fucking play sports, we do this entertainment shit, and that's about it.
And entertainment
revolves around music, YouTube, all that, comedy.
And a lot of entertainment shit not gonna pick up if you're not fucking funny.
A female, all they gotta do, you know what I'm saying, pop out a right titty and a left ass cheek, and they got, you know what I'm saying,
all they gotta do is have.
I mean, I'm not now my girl doing none of that, but you know what I'm saying? She could do something. What up? Bro, I told her, like, bro, it's easy for females to blow up, bro. They got it made when they come out on this social media shit. And I'd be like, bro, it's just, it's not. I ain't trying to speak on no sexist type shit or, you know what I'm saying, say it's lame. But it is kind of fucked up how easy females get it, especially on Twitch, bro.
If we being honest.
Niggas get banned so quick on Twitch.
Bitch, you done talking, bro. You about to get server muted. Bro,
it's just a podcast. We
posted. I'm saying, bro, but I'm trying to make a point, bro. I'm gonna fuck around and forget. Like, let me get my peace, man.
Go ahead.
But in this new age of making money, bro, like, we're like, in the most of the niggas that's making income off of the internet is so easy, bro. Cause you look up how fast nigga bitches was blowing up on Twitch doing them hot tub streams, bro. No hate shit, bro, but let's be real, bro. And I know this bitch from the borough right now, bro. Kiosha, bro. Kiosha started YouTube way after I did, bro. She started YouTube and had 1K in a week. No cap.
I swear to God.
And I said, I'm thinking to myself, if she kept on doing videos, she would have had an easy way out of the damn borough, bro. You know what I'm saying, bro? If she would have had the mind that I had and just started grinding it out, she would have made it out. Me, I got to be the funniest nigga on the East Coast. And the flyest, I gotta be the funniest, the flyest, and the most unique nigga on the East Coast.
All over, basically.
You know what I'm saying? I gotta be an all American dude. I gotta like this, that, and the third. You know what I'm saying? Niggas have to step out of shit.
What I will say is, when she started YouTube, you know what kind of videos she was making, bro?
How much, bro?
What kind of
videos, bro?
I hunting from Pennywise and running from car alarms.
Bro, but you used to break. Bro, but if we being honest, bro, that's my most viewed at the video.
And at the time, that shit was probably the shit. Like, you gotta think about it.
That was 2016.
Like, clowns and shit. The clown thing that everybody was like, oh, they clowns in the woods and shit.
And it was Halloween.
Tell me that shit that was during that time, that was stuff like that was trending. So it was like, why not?
It was like a couple of days from Halloween or after Halloween when niggas was doing a whole bunch of spooky shit. So we just staged a fake video. And the craziest thing about it was that one fake video, like, bruh, that nigga Jamari improvised off that shit so well, bruh. Like, it was parts in the video where in real life I was actually scared because this nigga would be banging on random shit. And I was like, nigga, what the fuck going on, bruh? And then that nigga set off that car alarm, nigga. You think we did that shit on purpose, bruh? Nigga set off the car alarm. We had to go hole in the house, bruh.
What?
Bruh, he set off my uncle car alarm because he bumped the car or some shit, bruh. And niggas had to go in the house. Shit was wild.
Damn.
But yeah, bro.
Yeah, that shit crazy.
Like, bro, I can do crazy amounts of videos, bro. Like if we talking about the videos now, most of my videos, like, bro, I sound like fucking Joe Budden, bro. You know, that nigga Joe Budden be hating because his music ain't never fucking land. But look, bro, my motherfucking videos, I was doing vlogs and shit. Basketball videos. I did a couple reactions. Was doing prank. Bruh, don't let me get started on pranks and shit. Niggas was doing the most, bruh. Bryce, I know you remember that damn prank, bruh. I know for a fact you remember that prank, bruh.
Actually, I want to shit like, I'm gonna say 2 or 3 nights ago. It was just like, this made me think about how my motherfucking mom was raising. I thought you just lost your fucking, I don't know what the fuck you were. Especially when I seen, like, you know what I mean? I beat 2 or 3 times a night. So I was like, that's nuts. Yeah.
Hell yeah, bro. I got stuff. I got video ideas right now, bro. Like I was telling, bro, Hazin, I got this video idea right now. Well, I'm going to set up the camera. I'm going to get my phone, and I'm going to call a whole bunch of my exes and tell them I want them back. Boom. That's a whole ass video. Just them reactions right there is just a whole ass video, bro. Niggas got discussion. Yeah,
you was at a point where your ass was fucking... So you was leaving the content to the point your ass made a video in the car.
Yeah, we was just doing random, bruh. I told niggas, I said, yo, whatever, like, bruh, by any means necessary, I was gonna just start dropping random short videos of niggas bullshitting. Okay. Like, bruh, whole time, like, bruh, I've been thinking out the box, bruh. Whole time.
Yeah.
Niggas can do pranks and all this other shit. We got like hella shit. Boxing videos, nigga. My fitness journey video. I gotta edit that the fitness journey video too. And now I got part 2 that's already recorded.
That's just that creative mindset.
You know what I'm saying?
I was watching something yesterday and I wanna speak about that right quick. Man, how y'all feel about Quavius Kinshaw coming back, man? His video dropped.
I like to cry.
Did y'all watch it?
Nice. Huh? That shit made me feel like, you know what I'm saying? Shit made me feel like, honestly, I started YouTube because of that nigga.
That's what I'm saying. So it was like seeing that going on, bro. Seeing, bro, almost retired and all that. Oh, and now he's transitioning to where he's going to start back making videos. I'm like, bro, it got to be a new set of Quavius Kinshaws, nigga. Niggas that's out here translating. Yeah. It got to be a new age of YouTubers.
That nigga mindset, like, think about how the nigga said, I hit 10 mil, I'm gonna retire. He came back, and his goal is to set so high. He said a second tenor that hits 10 mil, plus his main tenor.
25 on the main.
Yeah, 25. Yeah, on the
main, second tenor, 10 mil, and finish college.
He got four,
that's a lot of fucking pressure. I mean, that's a lot of shit on your back, nigga.
And so then honestly, do videos just, worth of two, like, for two channels? Like, bro.
Yeah, that's at least another year or two worth of hard work.
Or more.
Yeah.
That nigga's about to be making money out the ass, bro.
Yeah, definitely, definitely.
Cause all the merch, yeah. He about to have two channels worth of merch, and then a whole, you know what I'm saying? Like, bro, two ways. Yeah, bro, yeah,
I don't know if y'all know, but did y'all, watch his brother's channel? Again,
and I'm punching aunties, bro. Damn.
Motherfucker.
Like I was saying, that nigga goes
set
so I forgot what I was
going to
say. I'll forget that.
But do y'all watch his brother's channel?
Nah, I didn't even know that nigga had a channel.
Yeah, his brother got a channel. He bought his mama a hair business, bro. Oh, yeah, That's how much that man bought.
Yeah, he helped his mama start a hair business. I remember him talking about that shit.
Only time I seen his brother videos wearing them motherfuckers hoop.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's what I was finna get to the point what we was talking about, like the video creativity on ideas. In that video, he said something that caught me, bro. It's just that magic, bro. And that's just a fact. Like, in your life, when it comes on this, like, grinding stage, you got to find that magic in your life. You need to be able to have that drive, that mindset. Okay, I need to be able to wake up each and every day and get this shit done. Come up with creative ideas. Make use of what you do have, because it's going to pay off in the end of the day. Most people don't have that type of mindset. So they get somewhere and then they give up because they like, damn, this shit really ain't popping. But little they know, it's gonna have its peaks, but it's also going to have its uprise. You know what I'm saying? It's going to have its times where it come out.
That's why most of the niggas in the borough, it'll probably peak in high school because
this is a discussion I was waiting to talk. Oh, yes.
They
go ahead, bro.
High school, when they base their lives off fucking selling half, nigga, and selling weed to all these different niggas, that shit ain't gonna last at all. That shit don't last but for a split second. Because you gotta think about it. When you making fast money, you trying to get to the money as fast as possible, that shit gonna run out just as fast. So when that money gone, selling weed can get you shoes and shit, but that shit ain't gonna get you a house. It ain't gonna help your mama pay rent. It ain't gonna help your family at all.
That shit ain't gonna do no car payment, none of that bullshit.
Selling drugs in general, unless you just like an Italian mafia boss. I said,
if you're not growing your own weed, bruh, chopping up your own coke, if you not your own supplier, then nigga, it's a triangle scheme. You're not making money.
It's not in your fucking account. So you can spend that bitch, but when it's time to pay what you fucking owe, you're looking on goofy, and then, oh, damn, you broke as hell.
You basically making you a minute, winning
a minimum
wage. I'm
going to be 100% honest.
Registry, pay your debt.
I'm going to be 100% honest, bro. And I noticed this from a nigga, from a lot of niggas I know, you know what I'm saying? You know what I'm saying? I grew up from the streets.
Like, we know somebody right now.
Ain't nothing sweet.
One of the homeboys we used to hang with.
And for sure. But this is something I noticed, bro. If you still doing this shit, if you still out here selling weed, being a real street nigga and all that, turn 21, bro, that's the peak. 21, anything past 21, you not getting nowhere. Yeah, I'm telling you. Because I see so many niggas, they still living in the trenches, still living in a fucking bust down apartments, bro. I'm not going to name drop the complex on people.
Or with their moms.
So people get an idea of who I'm talking about. Because it's a lot of niggas I know.
Oh, they still with their moms. Bro.
Wait.
We can definitely, bro. We not trying to be on that shit, bro. It's chill, nigga.
I ain't trying to be on no ass, nigga. Look, I'm still living in the borough, too.
Hey, look, niggas, what? 30 years old, stepping out in Gucci, you know what I'm saying? Louis Prada, all the other shit, but you know what I'm saying? Going to parties, turning up, and still got to go home and understand that you 35 years old in your mama crib. You know what I mean?
Trying to live. Hey. Trying to.
Hey, you don't pay none of the bills in that motherfucker either.
Bro, except for when
maybe, you know what I'm saying, you gotta help with dinner or some shit. But when it comes, you know what I'm saying, you getting your clothes right, you throw that shit on, and then look at you. Like, man, what are you doing?
But let's get back to niggas peaking in high school, bro. A lot of niggas in the borough peak in high school, bro, because their priorities is based on who the niggas they hang around and their popularity, bro. Whole time.
I'm glad you just said
niggas
that.
Niggas is not original around this bitch. Niggas is not original around this bitch. They don't have their own original personality. They clout demons under the niggas that was already up there. You know what I'm saying, bro? And then next thing you know, when they get out into the real world, bro, when it's time to actually do some real shit, and you gotta actually find yourself and be your own person, bro, for you to grow. Niggas is out here stuck as fuck. That's why they can't make it out of the fucking borough.
This is why we're just talking. We were just, me and Buck was just talking about this shit. We were talking about you, and we was talking about this shit yesterday because we were reminiscing about the past, old days and shit. We were just talking about this shit like, damn. Like, niggas really do hit their peak after high school.
Mm-hmm.
Like, we were just talking about how, bro, in high school, you would have looked at niggas like Buck and them be like, damn, these niggas finna go out and be some shit.
That's what I'm saying.
And I'm not, this like, is no disrespect. Fest. Talking on my nigga Buck.
I love that nigga. I've known that nigga since the damn kindergarten.
Buck is my bro. I know that nigga since I was a youngin', bro. Since I was like, man, walking around short as motherfucker. Like, niggas thought I was gonna be a little ass nigga growing up. I know that nigga. But we was just talking about this shit. Like, bro, niggas thought in high school this man was gonna go D1 in football, go to the best college, everything. Bruh, I ain't saying bruh doing bad for himself. Bruh actually got him a job, he working his ass off.
Yeah,
he trying to
shit.
Do what a real nigga supposed to do. You feel me? But he said, that's because, bro, he said, bro, he in high school, he thought about like the decisions he made. He like, it took him now to realize like off of the decision he made. And it's like, in high school, those are your best years of your life.
Yes, you make
it. So you trying to have, you get so caught up in the fun, you never really think about, damn, what I'm going to do after I get out this bitch. So when it finally hit, he ain't really know what the fuck he was going to really do. It ain't like he don't want to go to college.
But it's like niggas are so stuck. Niggas was so stuck inside the motion, bro. Niggas was on that fast track with all the
and that's understandable, bro. Like, I got me a whole girl's home, mean this shit with disrespect, but I know that's true. Like, I understand. Like, when you in high school, you know what I'm saying, you got the popularity going for you. You got the niggas you fuck with, that fuck with you, females. Yeah. You know what I'm saying, you got everything going for you. You know what I'm saying? You caught up in that shit. So I understand. But then when you get in the real world, you got bills and shit you got to pay. It's like, damn, nigga. You got to think about what the fuck you going to do to put yourself in a better position. Most niggas don't know how to do that. That's why I understand where you coming from. Like, niggas really peak in high school.
Yeah, like, that's right. And I it's crazy because I remember a post, bro. This nigga made, they was getting on. You remember David? That's the only probably name I'm gonna probably drop around this bitch. But you remember David, bro? They used to clown his ass in high school. Bitch, bro. And bro made a post about a video. Cause they dropped the video. Dude was getting clowned in class, and that shit is not funny. It's funny, but it won't funny. And bro was like, niggas really peak in high school. Now I'm looking at these niggas. These niggas' name don't pop up at all no more. We all out of high school. No, none of these niggas pop up. We don't hear shit about these niggas. These niggas not out here living the high lifestyles. Most of them niggas either drug dealers, bro.
Yeah, that is fact.
And it's crazy because
in high school, you always heard about this person, that.
Oh, they about to do this. They about to do this. You don't hear shit, but niggas struggling. If not that, niggas is just chilling. Which I understand, once you get in a certain age, that's what you do. But, bro, it's niggas out here, bro. Like, take for example my homeboy Fred dad, bro. Fred's dad is like a hood hero. Everybody talks about that nigga, bro. That's the type of status I'm trying to be on, bro. Because, like, I was already establishing my connections, like, fucking high school, bro. Like, fucking, like, 10th going in 11th grade, bro. Because I wasn't the most popular nigga. I was known. I was a popular loner. Let's put it like that, bro. I was known by the niggas, but I was never good. I was never grouped in with them guys. Hold on. I was.
You can't even put it that way for real.
Hell no.
You just saying you want that kind of status, you really don't, nigga. Because, like, honestly, when you look at somebody, even if you don't think it's possible, you got to be able to tell yourself, like, I got to be better than this nigga someday. You got to look at yourself like, all right, I'm better than everybody. You don't go around saying that shit. But you gotta feel that way. Like, I'm gonna be better than
you
everybody.
You gotta be the best nigga. You got to be the best nigga in your mind.
He'd be like, hey, this nigga with shoes. He'd be like, all right, it's not like about the shoes. Like, okay, cool. He got them shoes. One day I'm gonna be able to buy that shit and some. Because one day I'm gonna have that shit that I wanna have. You gotta look at it from that point of view. Not just the status part of it, but just like,
hell yeah, success. But.
And Quez, I wouldn't call you a loner, like, in high school. Because, bro, I'm going to be 100% honest, bro. You had a more popular name than me, to be honest with you. I'm going to say this, though. The reason why, what made us two different
is because, you know, I was already a cool, friendly ass nigga. I try to make friends with everybody. That's just what got me my popularity. I ain't never be like, oh, this nigga art, this nigga that. With you, you were in high school, you was already so ahead of your time. You already knew who your snakes was. Yeah. So you knew who to associate with and who not to associate with. You feel me?
Yeah.
So I ain't saying you put yourself in that predicament, but you was like, all right, shit, I'm going to know who I want, my friends, who I don't.
That's
these
what I'm
rest
saying.
Of these niggas my associates, but the people in my circle, those are my homies. Those my people I fuck with. You feel me?
In the beginning, I already seen who was like the pack of the so-called popularity groups, bro, the niggas that everybody wanted to be under, bro. I knew said niggas, but niggas weren't fucking with me on that type of level, bro. You know what I'm saying, bro? So the people under them was doing the same thing. So I was like, all right, I'm gonna hang back. You know, I don't want to be a part of y'all niggas. You know what I'm saying? They was doing their own thing. These niggas, when I tell you, bro, and it kind of hurt me at first, bro, but that's what builds your personality, bro. That's what builds you. You know what I'm saying, bro? So you don't peak in high school. Niggas was going and taking beach trips, bruh, getting Airbnbs. It was like seven niggas deep. You know what I'm saying? And then they group chat. I ain't even gonna say that. That's too much information. I'm gonna leave it alone. But look, niggas was doing all that, bruh. I almost fucked up. Niggas was doing all that, bruh. We went to the beach, went taking trips. These niggas said, bruh, look, these niggas knew me. All these niggas knew me, bruh. Went and was speaking every other day in school, bruh. You think I got an invite? Nope. I had the time and the money because I was working, bro. I was working since the 10th grade. I ain't get no invites, none of that. And look at all these motherfuckers now, bro. These niggas all went their separate ways.
Yeah, that is a fact, bro. That is a fact. Bro. Like I said, bro, man, I want to say, like I said, I was a popular nigga. It's just because I was friendly. I tried to get cool with everybody. But that was kind of my, I want to say that was a downfall. That's what led me to the wrong path, but I had to get back on my path and realize, like, damn, these niggas ain't for me. These niggas ain't supposed to be in my circle. Like, with me, I was always trying to be cool with everybody because, you know what I'm saying? I ain't really care too much about who knew me. I just wanted to be that nigga, like, everybody, like, hey, I fuck with her.
You know what I'm saying,
like,
bro?
You know what I'm saying? That's my nigga, like, yeah, I fuck with him. That's just all I wanted to always be that.
Look, I ain't want a bunch of niggas down here fucking meat sucking me off every damn day talking about how you that nigga, bro. You that nigga. How be getting this? How be doing that? I ain't want to have no niggas in my circle. Them niggas that just telling me what I want to hear, not what I fucking need to hear. You feel me?
I just
wanted. I wanted to have motherfuckers in my circle that tell me, hey, Hazin, you my brody, bro. I fuck with you. You feel me? And that's what I thought I was getting. Then I seen how I strayed to the path of being in the streets, being in different gangs, you know what I'm saying? Yeah, but I got out that shit deep before when niggas, like, I was in the gangs in these school shits before niggas started pulling out guns.
I was
in here when niggas only boxing, scrapping, that's it. Then when niggas started pulling out guns, I had to back away because I started seeing how bodies was dropping. I was like, damn, but these niggas we went to school with.
And it's crazy.
And to hear about these niggas, dying, that shit hurts.
And cool believe, bro, I could have had went down that same path. I knew so many. And most of the people that I was cool with, bro, was the gangbangers, bro. Not because niggas were trying to be hard,
so crazy
because
quiz,
those
bro.
Were some of the coolest niggas.
Them motherfuckers was our family.
They was our family. So that nigga Damien, bro, rest his soul, bro. That shit hurt my damn heart.
Peace.
I was just finding
rest
out that nigga was my cousin, bro, before he died.
Bad.
Nigga got shot in his face, bro. That nigga J2
had
class with that nigga. We was cool. JT was the funniest nigga, bro. Real talk.
Hell yeah. He was a bitch. He used to get the bitches. He was a bitch getting nigga, bro. I ain't gonna say he was a bitch, but he was a bitch.
I was about
nigga,
to say,
bro.
Dad, the nigga's
like,
dead.
He was
bro.
A bitch getting nigga. Because he was funny, bro. He was funny. He was fresh and he was funny, bro. Like, I used to always get mad at that shit, though, because I was like, bro, I want on no hate and shit. I was just like, JT, bro. I asked this nigga one time, cause you know I used to be around Lalo and all them boys, you know what I'm saying?
Before,
so I used to be like, damn, I used to be around Draco, Lalo, all them boys, and I'd be like, JT, bro. I'm like, man, Kahari, that's the only nigga I'ma name drop, Kahari. I'm like, JT, bro, how you be getting your bitches, bro? That nigga used to always be like, bro, I'm just a cool ass, you know, everybody fuck with me. I'm like, you right, bro. And it took me a while to understand, but I remember I was in Polat class and then came in, had the whole class dying. I was like, damn, that's why. He a funny ass nigga, bro.
Funny,
he remind me so
dude.
Much of my damn brother, bro. So, it didn't make me no sense.
And he was one of them niggas that I feel like, bro, even at the high school, bro, like high school want that nigga Pete, bro. Because he won't focused on he won't focused on just being with one group of motherfuckers, bro. He was that one dude that niggas fuck with him so much because he was just a chill, funny, cool dude. He was funny, bro. He was cool. He didn't have beef with nobody but the niggas that was outside of the game, bro. That had problems with the game. You know what I'm saying? That we ain't gonna talk about that shit. I feel like I'm getting too descriptive about this bitch. I don't want nobody after my neck. But for real, bro. Like, that nigga was cool with everybody, bro. I didn't know him, the person that was like, man, fuck JT, bro. That nigga's a bitch type shit.
Yeah, it's just crazy. Niggas did not start name dropping his ass, shitting on his name until he was gone, bro. Before that, everybody was cool with JT.
That's
but then when his name, when his life was taken away, that's when motherfuckers started dissing him. You started hearing, oh, fuck JT, this, that. And like, damn. Yeah, bro. But one child of niggas that were fucking with him, like, come on, bro. Like, y'all niggas used to be like, oh, this my nigga, bro. He funny. He cool. Niggas used to be like, oh, go shop for that nigga JT, man. He got the pressure. But then as soon as he gone, now everybody like, damn, fuck JT and that. I'm like,
it's crazy because, like, bro.
That's why I ain't never could pick a side, bro.
You know it's truly a cool nigga, bro, when you barely know that nigga and that nigga speak to you outside of school, bro. Because that's one thing. High school, relations within high school, bro, them niggas was only cool with you because you had a class with the ass. You know how many people I see outside of school and them motherfuckers won't even open their mouth? That's why I don't.
I noticed that, bro.
And it's crazy. This the main reason why I don't speak to motherfuckers now. Not because I'm one of them niggas, bro. Because I'm not finna sit up here and embarrass myself. I done did that shit one too many times, bro. You walk up, oh, what's good with you, bro? Oh, what's up? And then just keep dipping. I'm like, damn, nigga, we supposed to be homies. Bitches too.
Motherfuckers be wanting you to basically be a fucking Naruto ass nigga.
You know what I'm saying?
You're chasing for attention, bro. I'm not chasing after nothing.
Nigga, want you fucking meat guzzle. Go ahead, bro. My fault.
What?
I said, bro, niggas want you to meat guzzle, bro. That's what it is, bro.
Yeah, that's a fact.
They want you to be out here like, you know what I'm saying? Crazy. But I've never been that type of person. Niggas know I never kissed ass and I never will kiss ass, bro. My demeanor demands respect, bro. You know what I'm saying? That's just the type of person I am, bro. I'm not gonna kiss nobody ass. I never did it on no job. I never did it at no school. Never did it for no teacher. You know what I'm saying, bro? And any nigga in HSB can tell you that, bro. That's how we all get down.
You a bitch.
I mean,
yeah.
Fuck you, whore. For real, though, man. Don't be one of them niggas that's in high school,
bro. It's hard and sad, though, bro. It's hard and sad to look at it. Like that, like down, man. Like, I remember one point of time in our life, like we used to be in school and we used to be like, damn, see, I can't wait to see how life gonna be at the school and then to see like the directions a lot of the people we went to school with are heading in, some locked up, some in the grave.
Some still out here.
You just be like, damn, man.
And it's crazy because half of the motherfuckers just look lost.
For real. Like, bro, like nigga, they don't know what the fuck they want to do. Or they like,
nigga, that's all.
They
bro,
only,
bro.
They only, only thing they turn to is a mic to try to rap because all the niggas sound the damn same.
Hell yeah.
So they speak about, talk about the same damn thing, bro.
Hell yeah.
And I know that's hard to a certain motherfucker here, but at some point in time, you got to think.
It's time to grow the fuck
these
up.
Motherfucking, these, y'all ain't doing that, but look, listen, I'm going to put y'all in the game. And I ain't going, I know this, we on Twitch streaming.
That's cool.
And we on Discord. I ain't going to get too specific. Like, I don't want that shit to sound all racist and all that, because I don't condone that shit at all. But y'all ain't doing that, but look, I'ma just be real. Y'all ain't doing nothing for all the niggas that's out here on that hood nigga rap shit, speak about the same shit. I'ma be honest. Y'all ain't doing nothing, making yourself look like a clown to these label people. Think about it, bro. Half of these motherfuckers are white. And I'm not trying to be racist or nothing, but you giving them what they want to see, bro. They all they want to see is a fucking black dude acting like a fool, bro.
And
guess what? If you dancing in a cage,
like a little fucking circus monkey. Of course, you doing what they want.
Yeah. You not gonna get it set.
I'm gonna be honest, bro. That's why I don't be always in my songs, always talking about, oh, I'm a real hood nigga. Oh, I do this and that. I shoot your cousin, shoot your brother, do this. Nah, bro, what the fuck?
But y'all prone bone your dead homie.
Don't get me wrong, bro. I will bump the hell out of some Chief Keef, some Young Nudie, some Young Boy, this and that. But I'm not gonna sit here and fucking do this rapping shit exactly like they do, because I know at the end of the day I'm not doing that, but playing in the hands to I'm not doing that, but playing into the hand of the you know what I'm saying, a white person. You feel me? If I'm a black person, I'm supposed to act like I'm civilized. I'm supposed to act like I'm not ignorant.
At least,
bro.
That shit, man, that shit dead, bro.
And it made me mad because I hate how my music don't get enough attention. But then you will look at somebody's music and it sounds just as
bitch,
like,
I will blow your motherfucking face off. Like, bro, that should have make it before you, anybody that's, you know what I'm saying, doing some like, different shit.
And Ghost, bro, nigga, it's hard as fuck to even... I can't even say off the dome. It's hard as fuck in general to name a nigga with at least his own versatile flow, or just in general a nigga that's talking about something that's gonna uplift your spirit.
Or something like, different, bro. That shit, that's something that don't like, sound nigga, like fucking trap music.
Every nigga that rap is rapping about smoking ops and killing niggas.
For real, that's all they talk about. It's like, bro, that shit is getting boring. I'm tired of hearing that,
Like, pull up to your nigga's house, shoot him at nighttime.
Like, bitch, is you telling the crime before you do it?
I ain't gonna say never. I ain't seen in a long ass fucking time. When I say a long time, I mean a long time. A nigga trying to like relay a positive message, even if it's like now some soft shit. But a nigga like trying to like tell
I'm gonna be honest. The only nigga that do that is Cove. No cap.
Hell yeah.
No cap.
And it's crazy, bro, because look at this shit, bro. The niggas that rap about that shit, not saying we want them to be on that shit. We don't want none of our brothers behind bars. Let's be real, bro. Niggas got a life to live, bro, but they choosing to live it a poor way. But these niggas not out here catching bodies. Hell, none of them niggas can fucking fight. Trust me, I've seen this shit for my damn self. I don't know what half of these niggas. And the niggas will buy guns just to not use them. Only nigga I know that got a fucking body right now, and I'm not name dropping for shit. Fuck me,
I'ma just be honest though, like dead ass, like bruh. What made me so mad too is half of these niggas will be the niggas that talk the most on the song, say they do this and do that. But they never went to fucking jail for these charges. They went to jail for either stealing a car, breaking and entering, or possession of a firearm. Not killing somebody. Not shooting at somebody. Like, yeah, bro, they'll get one charge and then, oh, they the hardest niggas in the streets. I'm like, nigga, you ain't street for real, bro.
Not even
you
ain't
had to put up with half of this shit, yeah, nigga. Like,
y'all know I caught that charge from, I took a car and then I had hit this nigga grandma with it. And then they had caught a cop on me and shit.
Ooh, yeah. You did
bro,
that?
What?
Yeah, bro, I ran nigga granny clean over.
When the fuck was this, bro? When was you gonna tell a nigga this?
Ran a nigga granny clean over, bro. I ain't know what to say, so I hopped out the hook. And I'm like, damn, I'm like, bitch had a good 3 years living in the tank anyway. How about you went and drove off? Fuck it.
Nigga, you lying.
Never got caught, though.
Nigga, but you just said you caught a charge, nigga, so, but you ain't never get caught.
Society,
man, this nigga lying. This nigga lying. I just caught this nigga in his own lie. This nigga said, the only charge he's caught, well, he caught was for that shit, and then he's going to turn around and tell him, so I ain't never get caught, though.
You know what I'm saying? Lie hard on stage.
Nigga lying hard.
But for real, though, that's how they, but dead ass, that's how the niggas in the street niggas be, though, dead ass, bro. That's exactly how they be. They be like, bro, I went to jail. Bro, I been in, bro, they'll do one breaking and entering charge. They'll get one breaking and entering charge, right? Looking get slammed with like 5 months. Come out.
Bro, I been in prison boxing niggas, bro. I'm a real nigga, bro. I do this shit for real, bro.
On prison, get their ass
on blood. I'm like, bro, you talking like a dumbass, bro. You is not on the shit you own, bro.
The whole time, bro.
I'm like, bro, I watched these niggas grow up, bro. I'm fucking 19 years old, bro. I watched these niggas grow up. Half of these niggas that's talking like they on their street shit, they is not with their street shit.
The crazy thing
I was watching their mama beat their ass coming in the house later.
Like, And it's crazy because I remember half of these, bro, majority, a
God,
good
bro.
Majority of niggas, we done seen get their ass beat by regular
dead
niggas.
Ass, bro. I was watching their mama drag them down the street for coming in the house late at night. Like, bro, I'm dead serious. Like, I'm for real, bro. I'm not going to name drop one, but it's a couple ass lying, niggas I can name lying. Out here. And I'm dead ass. Like, these niggas ain't on shit. These niggas used to be getting good grades in school. Now you talking about you toting a pole and dropping niggas. Come on, bro. I'm not with it, man.
Like,
stop
John
the cap.
Rambo,
if you ain't been a hood nigga
capping,
since
bro.
You came out the womb to now,
if
you're not a hood.
Thugged out,
you're
bitches,
not,
just stop
you
it,
a wannabe, yeah.
Like, I ain't gonna lie.
Sometimes being a hood nigga comes from your environment or your genes. You don't just say, hey, you don't just wake up one day and say, I'm a hood nigga, and you just
right,
die.
I'm gonna be honest. A hood nigga is just like a rich nigga. You either get born into that shit, you get born and raised into that shit,
or you pay the way into it.
Or either you just don't have nothing in your life going for you, and that's the only thing you turn to.
Yeah.
I'm gonna be honest with you, and it ain't no way nobody is that sorry of a son of a bitch that they can't get on their ass. They on the thing they can fucking do is hold a gun, rob niggas, sell weed, and talking about smoking folks in their grave. Like, come
the
fuck on, bro.
They
want to
be there. That shit cool.
Yeah, because that's what.
Like, bro, these niggas do not grow up like that, bro.
Hey, Chris, and I don't want to name drop, but it's families we know, and we know them niggas is they is sick. But they just claim they got a big gun, you know what I'm saying, to feel safe in the streets. But we know.
Who we talking about?
Motherfuckers in church every Sunday taking vacations every other month, nigga.
Take it. Whoa. What they name start with?
A family? No.
You said a family?
If I give a letter, nigga, it's over. Over.
The letter out of their last name. Letter out of their last name.
Over.
Literally last
what
night.
Over? What over go with? I ain't trying to be that way. You been to, when the last name in the Olive Garden, Quiz?
I ain't never been to Olive Garden.
Yo, when the last name in the Olive Garden?
I know what you're talking about. Of course. Hell yeah.
Hell fucking yeah.
I'm saying, bro.
Hold on, bro. And that's how it be, bro. Niggas swear up and down that they gangster dudes, bro. Niggas swear up and down. That is
like a real nigga, but it's niggas. I didn't see no niggas since I was, you know what I'm saying. I had to go. So I see this nigga, I be like, nigga, you straight? The fuck you? What, like, niggas sell weed sometimes when they ain't got no other option.
Bruh, that's what I'm saying. And the yo, it's crazy that we talk about this right now.
They
want
to sell people punk and they think that shit to make them look cool. Dude, nah, I got a gas.
Because they want to be like, bro, what? Whole time, bro. Like, nigga, you taken care of. You got shit that I know a lot of niggas don't, bruh. You whipping for free.
Come on, look, I got another free. Thing we can get in, a conversation we can get into. I know this shit gonna really hit. I know Quez wanna have a conversation about this. Cause we all niggas in this shit.
What's up, y'all should know
where I'm finna go at. What's up with these females wanting to be with a hood nigga? Like, what the fuck?
Oh, my motherfucker.
Because they don't wanna be with somebody.
Be with a nigga that's gonna
they don't know what the fuck they don't know what the fuck a hood nigga is.
Hold on.
Today,
beat
them the fuck up.
To be honest with you.
That nigga hood nigga is a nigga that with tattoos, either tattoos, dreads, and a gun.
They want some hard, rough-looking motherfucker, bro. And if we be honest, bro, I know what hood niggas look like.
Kevin Gates, young boy out of that nigga. No.
But the thing is, they don't realize a hood nigga will beat your ass like motherfucking Ike Turner. He will beat the brakes off you like you a damn nigga that stole some shit. We ain't,
you hear what Ike Turner said, bro? Her at that motherfucker, he told Tina Turner, bro. She was exhausted. She had to go to the motherfucker. She had to own the ambulance. That motherfucker was like, if you down me, I'ma kill you. And whispered that shit in her.
She had
to sleep with that shit, bro. She said, nigga said, if you die on me, I'ma kill you, bruh.
Whole time. But nah, bruh. That's some fuck-ass shit because I've been hit with that, bruh. Because niggas think...
Hey, hold on. Let me add this on. And then thumped in her forehead.
Man, get the fuck out of here.
These bitches grow up off a baby boy and then they start...
Ain't that shit
that's
cool.
What they want.
But nah,
that's
bruh.
What they do.
And it's crazy because Bryce, bruh, we all in this... Bruh, well, I can't say we all, bruh. But me, Bryce, Chris, bruh, we all in this damn boat, bruh. We are not hood niggas. I mean, I'll beat a nigga ass if I have to, bro. That never been the problem, bro. But nigga, by any long shot, we are not hood niggas. Not putting down no hood niggas or none of that stuff. We are not hood niggas.
I got a mindset to get money. Me being around a hood nigga and me knowing niggas don't make me a hood nigga. Me being in an environment with hood niggas don't make me a hood nigga. Well, I'm not in a position where I gotta have this money. I gotta go out and get it. I gotta sell drugs. I gotta do all this shit. I'm not in that kind of position. I'm in a position where I'm not gonna say, you know what I'm saying? I'm rich as fuck. You know what I'm saying? I'm paying. I'm a middle class. I'm living regular.
To be honest. In the generation that we live in, most niggas choose is to be hood niggas by choice. They don't fucking
get put in that shit by force.
They choose to be hood niggas. Bro. They
think it's fucking cool.
Yeah, for real, bro. They think that shit gonna get
to be a hood nigga.
I'm gonna be 100% honest, bro. I know, cause I was one of them niggas at one point in time. They think being a hood nigga gonna get you bitches, all the attention, make you popular. Is they think all that shit, like, bro, do you not understand, bro? When you get around that age of 19, 20, that shit is not cool no more, bro.
That shit is some kiddie shit.
When you get around our age, you at that age where you like, damn, I want a car, bitch. I want a crib, bitch. I want my privacy.
When I see a nigga I know, you feel what I'm saying? Flashing a gun. And you ain't even blew that bitch yet. You know what I mean? You ain't blew that bitch ain't nobody. You ain't blew that bitch.
Bitch ain't got no ammo.
I don't niggas. They'll buy a pole and go shoot that motherfucker off somewhere in the woods.
Just to have it, man. Like, just to feel cool.
Swear down, they been through them shit.
Like, bro, and it's crazy. Because I've been... You know what I'm saying? I've been in plenty of situations where it could make me a hood nigga. Niggas done been through shit. I done been through shit. I don't consider myself as no hood nigga, though. And it's crazy. Because let's be real, bro. Let's be real with ourselves, bro. I've never been no sugarcoating type of nigga, and I've never been no nigga that, you know what I'm saying? My life is pretty much open book just a little bit. I've been curved by bitches because they wanted a hood nigga, which doesn't make sense to me. You want some, like, what's the difference between a regular nigga? What can a hood nigga provide for you that a regular nigga can't?
Not a damn fucking thing.
But an ass whooping.
I was just finna say that.
What you want, some? You think a hood like nigga I gonna said, bring bro, you I some? You want a hood nigga? You want a nigga to bring you some money, bro? I can bring some paper to the table, bro. You want to go out to eat? Bitch, we can go out to eat. You want your nails and feet done, bro? It don't gotta be dirty money, nigga. Been working a long time.
The bitch ain't attracted to dick, shoes, nails, and hair and fucking money, nigga. They not attracted to fucking mutual feelings no more. Like,
hell no.
If you feel like you got enough money. Spared to go buy her a new purse, that's your bitch automatically.
Until
your ass get caught up in the jam, and you know what I'm saying, she not putting no money in your books, and she had to catch a hella dick from other niggas, but you gotta be loyal because, you know what I'm saying, your other choice, you know what I'm saying, is John, you know what I'm saying, with a honey bun, you know what I'm saying, crispy cake, all that other shit, and you think she's sweet.
I'm just saying.
That's why I'm glad I got my girl, because I swear to God, when I was looking at my history, my past, bro, my old lifestyle, bro, and I think about all the other females, like, bro, I had them bitches only because I had the title above my head, that hood nigga title. Yeah. I was around a certain motherfuckers I was around. Like, I'm gonna be honest, if I would have been myself, I don't think bitches would have really followed me, bro. And I'm gonna be 100% honest, like, I don't really give a damn. At that time, I did. Now I don't really give a damn, cause it's like, I never been a person that really craved for attention, but at the same time, I always been a person that wanted people around me to the point where I know I don't have to worry about it's a bunch of demons around my circle that's ready to take my life. You feel me?
Exactly.
Like, you know what I'm saying? We all got our demons. We all got our battles. You feel me? And we all feel like when we step out that door, it's a snake waiting out there in the grass for our ass. You feel me?
Yeah.
So that's why I always felt like, you know what I'm saying, I needed to have motherfuckers around me so I can know. Like, you know how niggas be like, damn, I'm always protected wherever I go. You feel me? Thanks. I got niggas everywhere. That's why I always wanted to be like, you know what I'm saying, cool with everybody. I know I wasn't going to be touched. But then when I started seeing how life was, and I started really getting it, like, involved around the street, starting to get into games for real, going around my cousins and shit, seeing the motherfuckers they was around and shit. Like, I was like, damn, this shit kind of scary. And then when we was talking about with JT, after that shit happened, oh boy, that really took the whole game shit out of me, bro. Yeah. I was like, hell no. I could see how a nigga that really was a chill ass nigga, not really that much involved around the street shit. He just was around hood niggas.
Yeah, he was just that nigga.
And it got him caught up. And I seen how that got him caught up, and I was damn,
and
bro.
And the crazy part about it,
I don't want that shit that for nigga, myself, bro.
That nigga JT was so out of the way, bro, when he died. That's just
yeah, he was, bro. Like, he, bro, I'm gonna be honest, bro. I never seen a game shit out of JT like that, bro.
Yeah, bro. I didn't
man,
see that
only thing I seen
like
out
was
of JT was him around. You feel me? I ain't really see him like, throwing up no signs, walking around with a flag. If niggas seen him like that, then I ain't seen him like that. But like, if niggas seen him like that, they seen him like that. I ain't seen him like that. When I was around JT, he was always been a funny nigga, had some bitches around him. You know what I'm saying? He was around his hood niggas. You feel me? And to see that still, you don't even have to be in the game, bro. You don't even have to be in the game to still get touched, bro. My mama always told me a bullet don't got nobody name on it. That bitch can hit anybody. And I seen how that played out, and that's why I was like, bro, I don't even want to be with that street shit, bro. I want a better life for myself. You feel me?
And that's why I formed fucking HSB, bro. HSB is the group of misfits, bro. We the motherfuckers.
Mm-hmm.
We the motherfuckers that just quite don't fit in, bro. And it's crazy how many groups that is like that, bro. But that's just how I feel, bro, with the brethren that's inside this bitch. It's just like, bro, we don't quite fit in, bro, but we perfect where we at. For sure. We all got our own redeeming qualities and own unique ways about how we go about shit. You know what I'm saying?
Hey, we got to write a bit of a song for our fall asleep on fucking stream.
Bitch. Of course.
What's the title of the stream, man?
Bruh, no sleep.
And you mean to tell me y'all can't apply that? What time is it? Hold on.
It's about 4 o'clock.
3:19. Shit. We can end this in like 10 minutes if y'all can hang in.
Ten more
minutes. Make it 3:30. We end this bitch. You feel me?
Yeah, but nah, for real though.
Shit. What else?
Christian came up with a fire ass topic. I ain't gonna lie, that's almost heat. You're packing
your bags for the
niggas said. Niggas supporting niggas inside the town. I'm just like, fuck no.
What about how y'all see the age of life right now with money?
Wait a minute, what you say, Chris?
I said that's the real shit though, cause like if them motherfuckers really your mans, they really supposed to support your shit. And put your shit out there. You see what I'm saying?
I never had a problem posting nobody's shit, bro. I used to post Jamari music in the damn shit, bro. But then I realized that shit won't spin him back. I said, oh, nah, I'm sorry, bruh. And I hate the name drop. That's my guy. I still love him.
I'm going to be honest, bro. Like I said about that topic, bro. Man, that's what it is, man.
Yeah, it is.
All I can say with that is, hey, continue to watch how y'all watching. Don't come talk to me later on, bruh. Straight up.
Throwing 50
I ain't trying to be a fucked up person, but.
This could be, you know what I'm saying, up then. You feel me?
Yeah. I ain't trying to be a fucked up, but my train don't wait on nobody, bro. I got tickets right now. If you a homie, you got a ticket. I'm my train. Y'all on my train with me. If I make it out, no, best believe. HSB, INF, everything that I'm associate with. You know what I'm saying? I'm in. They going with me. You feel me? Everybody else, you really ain't on that train ride, man. Once all it takes is one of us to blow, and we all gonna go. That's how I always grew up off of. You feel me? Matter of fact, and I'm gonna be honest, it was a hood old head that told me that. You feel me? I ain't even gonna name drop. It was that nigga Kodak Dad. You feel me? I got interviewed by Kodak Dad for my music shit. And he was like, "Hey, look, man, I'm gonna be honest. How y'all really need to set the foundation to y'all group?" He said, and I even post a picture of that shit on my story later on. So niggas know I'm not capping, bro. And you'll see Kodak dad and you'll be like, damn, he look just like his dad. He told me, he was like, look, how y'all group need to be is, look, if one of y'all blow, y'all all gonna go, because at the end of the day, y'all supposed to be family before anything. Y'all might not be blood family, but y'all supposed to be family. Support one another. Lift each other up when one is down, you feel me? Even from carry each other on. Y'all both, y'all all gonna go up. And I was like, damn, when he said that shit, like, yeah. I said, fuck the niggas that ain't supporting my shit, bro. Fuck them. Everybody needs haters. Everybody needs a motherfucker that like, damn, he ain't gonna really do nothing. But then when you prove the motherfuckers wrong, watch how they asking for a fucking handout. Hell yeah. Watch they be the first in your DMs. Oh, bro, I went to school with that nigga.
You see a lot of that shit. The first places that you start seeing that shit is within your own family, bro.
That's a fact.
Your first group of haters is gonna be the motherfuckers in society within your own bloodline. Those be
like, if they family, they can tell you anything. They can start your shit in the worst of ways, but since they family, they got it right.
Yeah, and cuz, I'm gonna be honest, bro. I'm not even gonna lie, bro. We both cousins, bro. Yeah. Listen, our family the hardest, bro.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah.
Listen, our family is the hardest because we got a couple of rich family members. We got our slum family members. Yeah. We got our middle class family members. And they ain't all together like they used to be, bro. My mom used to tell me back in the day, y'all all used to be together. Family reunions. And they used to be big. They don't do that shit no more like that.
Nigga, if at all, bruh. Niggas don't.
They don't contact each other. No, none of that. And it's really.
And I noticed that you know what I'm saying? When Uncle Jay died.
Yes, bruh.
Uncle Jay died, bruh. It was like shit hit the fan, bruh. Because niggas was running at his house taking his shit. But I'm not going to put all the family business out there. But niggas was moving kind of shiesty, bruh. Like, it was foul as fuck.
That's a fact, bruh.
Yeah.
That shit really crazy, man. That's tough. But like I was saying, though, because this is going to probably be the last topic right here. Yeah, it's going to probably be the last topic. Man, how y'all boys feel about today's society on making money? Like, you know what I'm saying? It being multiple ways. It's like, true, for man. Far as, like, with COVID, since COVID done really popped off. Yeah. You feel me? Like, how do y'all feel about that? Like, now you can do the online marketing. If you really want to make some money, you can go to school, get invested into real estate, start making your money like that. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Like, there's multiple ways, like, you know what I'm saying? To make bread, bro. Streaming. All these females out here, OnlyFans, how y'all feel about that shit? You feel me?
Bruh.
It's multiple ways motherfuckers make money right now, like with COVID and shit.
I say, bro, honestly, bro, it's weird, bro. It's just like, what the fuck you laughing at, nigga?
Every time I throw that nigga down, nigga like, nigga, ask something else.
Now you see what I be talking about, bro. Because it's like, once you feel like Hazen stop talking, that motherfucker add on another sentence. But look, bro, nah, whole time, bro. Like, bro, money, the way to make money in nowadays, it's weird, bro. Because it's never been like, niggas that was doing this a couple years ago, they won't tell nobody how to do this. But you got niggas that's trying to tell niggas how to do this, but it's like, it's weird now. It's weird as hell. This is like, all right, how do I get on? You know what I'm saying? Everybody doing it. There's so many different methods to do it, bro. But it's like, since everybody doing it now, bro, the niggas that's doing it, it's not easy for them to pop like that. You know what I'm saying, bro? Like, a couple years ago, you started the YouTube, nigga, you was destined to be good, bro. You know what I'm saying? Or you was destined to at least be somewhere. Nowadays, everybody want to be a YouTuber. Back then, rap, I mean, it's just kind of the same with rap, though. I mean, motherfuckers, it was never promised. It was like, bro.
Yeah, it was never.
Getting into rap is damn near like getting into the NBA. You know what I'm saying, bro?
Yeah.
But Forex, you got so many trader niggas out this motherfucker, it makes me sick.
They got a clan going on. We talked about
fucking cult.
No, Forex. No. Dead ass. Forex is like a fucking pyramid scheme.
But they are the clan, my nigga. They selling they soul for money.
I ain't trying to be that nigga. You see, Agent K went over that Forex shit. And you know how?
How?
Because he had motherfuckers under his belt. Yeah, that was like helping this nigga get his papers. Let me ask you a question. not trying to be that nigga.
Where them niggas
but you know niggas that was posting, but you know niggas that was posting his story, and you know niggas that was like on top of that Forex shit too. He's still doing that shit. He's going crazy. But it's them same niggas doing it as well.
I can tell you a handful of high school niggas, Chris, me and you both know half of these niggas that you would not see 4X trade under their shit no more. I don't see them posting them all.
Everybody was a fucking trader.
Yeah, but look, now I don't see none of these niggas, and they was like, oh man, imagine having your school tuition paid for this, that, and the fifth. I don't see none of these niggas now.
That shit was damn sure a fucking friend.
They said, fuck that, we getting scammed.
Yeah, I mean, bro, because we know niggas that was in that. That was like, bruh, these niggas was putting in money, they was losing money, and they just backed out. And then again, it was niggas inside there that's just not doing this shit no more because the shit teachers and niggas not looking out for them no more. They done fucking climbed to that peak. My boy, Big Dog Adrian, and climbed to that peak, bruh. But the niggas that was following him, I don't see them no more. You tell me what happened.
I'm gonna be honest, bro, and I don't never try to down to Adrian. Adrian worked for his shit. He really did. And he got to where he wanted to be at.
Yeah.
And you can't really hate on the man. He did what he had to do. But I always said that Adrian had multiple ways he could have blown, you feel me?
Hell yeah.
Could have really blown in the football shit. Bro was in football. Had good colleges won his ass. He was into the YouTube shit. Could have went. He about to go bid with the YouTube shit now that he got the money from 4X. But at the time when he was focused on 4X, he wasn't studying YouTube. Then he came back out of nowhere now that he got his new girl, the money.
Now
he finna blow up now because, you know.
And now that nigga can travel. He got the money to travel and do.
Look, them niggas are talking to King Sid right now, bro.
Hell yeah.
That shit crazy.
Hell yeah.
That's what money is
doing. So it's like,
you can start doing more shit once you unlock that key, bro. But for niggas, it's different for every niggas, bruh. Different strokes for different folks, because this is how that works. You know what I'm saying? But that's why I was looking at niggas so goofy, because everybody was trying to hop on the 4X train because they felt like it was so much easy money with that, bruh. But I'm looking at y'all niggas, I'm like, bruh, niggas out here goofy. The same thing that worked for that nigga don't mean it's going to work for you, bruh.
What niggas lost when that shit came out. That's what they lost the mindset of.
Yeah, bro.
Like, that shit applies with everything, music, everything. When 4X came out, they thought it was going to be something that everybody could get rich from. No, bro. If that were the case, everybody could make it to the NBA, NFL, music, industry, all that. But no.
If you're not constantly working towards that shit, you don't really want it.
Yeah.
That's just a fact.
That was the fact. Niggas wanted to quit bad. That's it.
Niggas prioritize what they really want, bro.
You know what I'm saying? Like, say you want to do this shit, but you put that shit behind. Like, I put that shit behind me sometimes. Like, I got to get on that shit. But say if you want to do this YouTube shit, like, I really want to take it serious. I can't do this shit I want to do now. I'm doing now.
Hell yeah.
I got to actually put time and effort into that shit.
And that's a lot. That's how it was for me, bro. Because
ain't no half-ass in that shit. Niggas that half-ass something and then be like, oh, damn, how that shit ain't work for me? Because you ain't putting your full effort. And they be looking goofy when, like, you know what I'm saying? It's time for rewards. You ain't get none.
Bro, facts, bro, because it's the same way with motherfucking anything, bro. Cause I know my downfall was bitches. I go duck class to go meet a bitch right now. I would call off of work to go meet a bitch. You know what I'm saying, bro? Because priorities, a nigga, the money was already there, cause of that mouth. But like, you know what I'm saying?
My downfall was just money.
Oh no, Chris, maybe you was just pussy whip.
Who was pussy
whip? Hell yeah.
How the hell I was pussy whip? You making it seem like you was, bro. Okay, we ain't gonna get in that discussion, bro. You like to fuck me over, you bitch. But look, bro, it's just like, bro. If we being honest, bro, it's like, bro. Some people, and it's just, I got that granddaddy in me. That's all that it is. My granddaddy was a man whore. Grandma said to herself. But honestly, bro, your priorities is where is that? Now you see what a nigga doing. All I do 25/8 is work. I'm trying to get out. I'm not saying I'm trying to get out this bitch, bro. But I'm trying to get out of lower to middle class, bro.
Facts.
I'm trying to be a high class gentleman. I want to be making money. I want to at least be, if not wealthy, bro, well off. You know what I'm saying? Like,
hey, look, bitches, 301.
Mm-hmm.
Say your goodbyes.
331, bro. Hey, Bryce, close this bitch out, bro.
I'm gonna say, appreciate y'all good looking gentlemen coming through. You know what I'm saying? Little sexy butts, you know. Yeah, I always got a special place in my heart, Emma. You know what I'm saying?
To take our ass like Jimmy Lee, man.
Yeah. Y'all always love. Y'all always got a special place on the bed. All you got to do is come through. You know what I'm saying? The rules imply. You walk through this door, your drawers drop.
This nigga here. Yeah, he had one of my fucking prison inmates, bro.
I'm saying.
Hey, it's up to you how you step in this bitch. You know what I'm saying?
But listen, man. Like the dude said. Like the dude said, bro. Y'all niggas, we love y'all niggas, man. The Twitch chat, man. YouTube, if you watching this on the damn platform. We're going to have, what's today? Bitch, Saturday, right? But look, bro. Whole time, bro. We love niggas. You know what I'm saying? No hate out this motherfucker, bro. We just cool dudes doing this shit, bro. If you ain't already did that, follow all the socials. Follow me on Twitch. Subscribe to the channel, bro, if you haven't already, bro. You know what I'm saying, bro? And if you made it this far, bro, nigga, you love, bro. Y'all make y'all own decisions, bro. Don't get stuck behind no damn clout demons, bro. Don't. The motherfuckers is dangerous, bro. I'll wrap up. You know what I'm saying, bro? And, bro, be safe out in these damn times, bro. That's all I can damn tell you, bro. But we gonna try to do this bitch, what, every Saturday? That's what y'all wanna do? Y'all wanna do this bitch Saturdays?
Yeah, Saturdays, bro.
All right, we done chose today. First, it's gonna be Friday Night Fights. Saturday night, no sleep stream podcast. Oh, shit. That's... Hey, man. Man, we out just like those, bro.
Why y'all ass say, bro?